Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Dr. Anand Nair, and I'm working as professor, researcher, and scientist in graduate school, Dutan University. I welcome you all to the day two of research methodology. So today I'm going to give you lots of information, lots of new knowledge, and lots of research-based information. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the session. So let us first of all start with the day two with an amazing information, which I would like all of you to please document in your copies. But no problem, I will be sharing all the websites to Dr. Rupa after this session will be over. So let's start with some of the tools. Now we find the problem that we are all handling with the PDF. We all handle with Word, Excel, and we have to find some softwares in order to edit the PDF, in order to extract some information. We want to convert something from Word to PDF and even to Excel to PDF, all other things. So I would like to give you a one-stop solution that is called hipdf.com. So if you see this website, you can find that you can compress the PDF, which means that if your PDF is about 300 MB, you can even compress it to less than 10 MBs. You can even do PDF to Word, Word to PDF, exec, you can say, merge PDF, split PDF, edit PDF. And even if the PDF is having a password, or if the PDF is not getting copied, or if there is any secure-based option that is available, even you can unlock this PDF from here. Okay, you can even put an encryption password over here. You can even crop the PDF from here. So this is the one-stop element, and everything that you see right now is free of cost. No need to install any software on your computer. This is the one-stop website that you can have. Now, the second thing which I would like to aware all of you. Now, if suppose we have to find some information with regard to some website, we want to take some screenshot of a particular website. We want to have some screenshot of an image, anything we want to have. You can see that there is a website called screenshot.guru. This is one of the best website, and it captures the high resolution screens of websites and even the tweets. So this is a one-stop website that you can use in order to screenshot your files and documents in order to produce some excellent results, I can say. Now, the next website I would like to give all of you, that we all want to do some primary data collection. We want to have some data set. We want to go for some questionnaire based things, and we want to make some survey or anything. Even if you want to make a feedback form, like today I'm having a meeting, I want to make a PDF form that how do you like my session? I want to take my feedback from your side, and I want to do some data analytics, everything. So I would like to give you one website. You can same is called typeform.com/surveys. So typeform.com/survey is one of the easiest creator tool. It's a free of cost tool in order to create tons of templates and in order to create your own survey form. So if you are a management student, or whether you are into applied mathematics, or whether you are a statistician, so if you want to collect the data, this is the best tool in order to create your own survey. So I repeat the website again. It is called typeform.com/surveys. This is one of the best websites that you can see. Now, the next website which I would like to aware all of you in order to learn data science. No doubt we have Coursera, no doubt we have Kaggle, we have other websites. Okay, so I would like to aware one of the best website that you can see, that is called Data Elixir. This is the worst, this is the one of the best website that you can see in order to be the top in the world of data science. And even it covers machine learning, data visualization, analytics, and strategy. And even you can see, you can sign up for all the data levels, and even you can get all the data sets from this website. This is a total complete website that many people don't know, that this is one of the best websites in the world of data science. Now, the next website which I would like to give you all, that many people say that, sir, we want to download some magazine, we want to have some computer magazine, we want to read it free of cost, but we all know it is Maxter, but Maxter is paid. But I would like to give you one website today. The website is known as DownMags. DownMags.net. So with this website, you can download tons of websites with regard to computer, electronic technology, films, fashion, for men, for games, health, anything, whatever you want to have. I can say 90% of the magazines in the world are available free of cost in this website. So this is a particular website that all of you must use and do that. Now, the next tool which I would like to give all of you, the next website which will give you a straight, I would like, please, if any person is joining or please leaving, please don't disturb. So the next website which I would like to give you all, through which you can just, you can say that download any book in the planet, whether it is of Springer, Wiley, or anything, whatever you want to have in the planet, you can do from this website. This is called pdfdrive.net. So please remember, this is called PDF Drive. And if you just search any book, like suppose if I want to search some book on discrete mathematics. So if I just type discrete mathematics, and I press enter, you can see that out of the word, you can say that all the books that are available in the world of data or discrete mathematics, it will be available in front of you. So if suppose I want to download some book on machine learning, every book is free of cost. So suppose if you want to download this book that is called this book only, like machine learning step-by-step guide. So just have to click over here. And after that, let me give you some practical experiment. So click on this download. And after that, it will just take one formality to check the remote file health. And after that, in just a second, the book will be downloaded from at your computer. So after this, it will give you the download link. Yeah, I get it. So just click on this download PDF. And in a matter of second, you can see that the book is downloaded. And you can see the full book is in front of me right now. So you can download any of the tons of the books over here on this pdfdrive.net. So you can find the categories in terms of editors, biography, politics and news, computer, most popular, anything, whatever you want to have. You can have free of cost. And even you can see that the books are readily available and the books count is increasing like anything. Okay. So let us start with some research tools now. Now, let me tell you, first of all, in order to search a research paper, so many people say that, sir, we want to search a research paper. The best website is called scholar.google.com. But 90% people don't know that this website we don't appreciate for searching the paper because you don't have proper control in searching. You don't have the proper control over predatory journals. You just get an information and you can download, but some you can download. But I will give you some search engines today that if you are searching for a research paper, no matter what scholar you are, so use these websites in order to search the research paper. So the first website which I would like to give all of you is called science.gov. This is one of the best websites to search the research papers. Now, after that, I will be giving you some demonstration. Now, suppose if I'm searching researching on an area called cloud computing, I just click on this search. So with this, you can find more than 60 databases and 2200 scientific websites. And there is no need to worry. Now, let me tell you what is the magic behind this website. So whenever I want to write a paper, if I want to get some literature, I want to find some information regarding the baseline study of the researchers, I use this website only and in order to get the fetching of the information. So this website is even having machine learning in that in order to understand your search. But after that, I will be giving you more advanced websites. So it'll take some time to load. So meanwhile, we will just have another website. So the second website which I would like to give all of you is called core.ac.uk. This is another best website for open access research papers. Now suppose if I'm researching on the area for ad hoc networks. Okay, so just click ad hoc networks and click on search. So you can find all the books over here in terms of ad hoc networks. So similarly, if suppose you are researching on any other activity called cloud computing, so just click on activity and click on search. Now see what I'm going to show you right now. So you can even tweak from over here, from the year. Okay, suppose I just want the literature only from 2015. So only those papers which are available from 2015 will be listed. And even if suppose you want to search a particular journal, like suppose how many papers are published in the term of censors and in terms of scientific reports, I just need those papers. So you can say, yes, it is free of cost. So you can download any paper over here. So suppose if I want to download this paper, I just click over here. And after that, it will readily download this paper immediately. So this is one of the best websites that you can see in the world of scientific research. You can see no need to go to any website of censors. So immediately you can download all the papers. And the most important beauty of this website, now see over here, please. After that, I will be putting those questions. Thank you so much. Already we have wasted 15 minutes. So you can see over here. So if I suppose. Okay, so you can see the cloud computing from date picker, okay, I just take from here through here, which means I just want a result from only 2016 onwards. So I just click over here. And after that, it readily improves the research over here. So which means all the papers that are automatically published from 2020 or 2018 onwards, so you can find all the results. So even you can do the discussion with regard to transportation, cloud computing, and even you can search for data sets also. So you can see that this is a comprehensive website in order to search for the research papers. Okay, you can even go for multimedia. You can even go for data. These are all the data sets and even the public access. So this is what we can say, that in that world of research, these are the search tools that you must use in order to search the papers. So suppose if I just want a language from English, so it will just refine the research again. And after that, I just want a repository only from Springer. So suppose if I take like Journal of Computer Science, that is from Springer. So you can say that if there is no article, it will not give you anything. So similarly, if you suppose if you are searching on Internet of Things, you can just click search. So depending on the refinement, whatever you want to do, you can do like this. So right now this website is somewhat slow, no problem. So the next search which I would like to give all of you is known as base-search.net, basc-search.net. So don't worry, just please understand, I will be giving all these links to Dr. Rupa, you can take it from her. So you can see that there are about 8,292 sources. Now suppose if I'm researching on, that is the area for blockchain. So suppose if I just search blockchain, now see what will happen. So it is giving me the search over here. So all the blockchain based papers. But suppose if I just want a publication only from 2019. And if I just want the subject called blockchain. So I just click on enter. And after that, it will start importing the results for me. So you can see that all the papers that are available on the latest area in the terms of blockchain, it is all available. So which means that it is giving you better capability and better information as compared to Google Scholar. So the most important thing is that none of the paper will be from predatory journals. All the papers will be from SCA journals or Scopus journals. Okay, so all those journals that are recognized, those who are having credibility, only those journals will be coming in front of you. So you can go for detail view, you can check in Google Scholar, you can click over here, you can download them, anything, whatever you want to do, you can do from here, this website. So these are the three websites right now, I repeat. One is called science.gov, the second is called core.ac.uk. So you can find more information, like suppose if I just want to search on more journals or repositories, anything, whatever you want to have. Suppose Springer has published, you can see it has published 637,283 papers. So I just want only those papers from Springer. So I just click over Springer. Okay, so this website is somewhat not working. Okay, so I just click on over here and I can make the references from there. So the next website which I would like to give all of you is called RefSeek. Very important website for all of you to understand. So suppose over here I'm doing my research on wireless sensor network. So suppose I just type wireless sensor networks and I click on search. So if anything, anywhere which is available on sensor networks with regard to DOI number, with regard to Wikipedia, everything that is available from the last date to the current date, you can even specify over here. This is known as the practical Google for finding the references with regard to your keywords. Okay. So suppose if I just put security. So all those papers which are having security with regard to wireless sensor networks will be listed over here. So this is how you can find the topic, subtopic. And after that, I just find like another topic. I just put on double exclamation mark and I just put like energy efficiency. So I just need more paper on energy efficiency and security. So you can see that all those papers that have energy efficiency and security will be listed over here. So this is how we define the research inbuilt. So that's how this Google search will not give you much, but this type of searches will give you the best tool in order to search the papers. So this is how we do the research. But now I'm going to give you the best and the master website that you will be all stunned to know. Yesterday, I told you that if you want to find some research papers, you can use Google Scholar, or today you have just changed your mind by these websites. But today I'm going to give you one website that do the literature view for you. Okay, you don't have to go for any searching. This, you just have to type the keywords or select the keywords. This website will have the deep learning and neural networks in order to do and refine the search for you. So the answer is called Author Mapper. Very important research tool, everybody. It is one of now. Now suppose if I'm just searching on. Now suppose if I'm just searching, like suppose now let me tell you what amazing thing it is having. Suppose I'm searching on Bluetooth. Okay, I just want to make a thesis on Bluetooth. So my guide told me that let's research something on Bluetooth. So I just want to find, first of all, what are the areas or the subjects in regard to Bluetooth and what are the papers that are being published in Bluetooth. So I just click on map it. Now see what will happen. So all the papers, you can say that till date, I can say 20,862 articles are there on Bluetooth. But now I just refine my search, but I want Bluetooth in the world of IoT. So I just have to click anything. I just have to find the keyword and I just click on Internet of Things. So I just click on IoT. Now it will give me those papers that are having IoT and Bluetooth. But inbuilt, I just want to add much more things like fog computing. So suppose if I click on fog computing, it will give me the best parameters with regard to fog computing as well as IoT and Bluetooth. So that is the reason, everybody, you don't have to go for searching for any papers on Google Scholar. These websites will do the search for you. So inbuilt, you can even do for like big data analytics, so you can refine your search better and better. Now suppose if I'm doing research on big data, now see this, what will happen. So if I click on map it, now see this, all the articles which are belonging to big data. So all the articles, which means 660,606 articles are available on big data. But now I just want to classify my big data with regard to healthcare. So I just research on breast cancer. Now suppose, now see what will happen. So there are about 1617 articles with regard to breast cancer, and it is concerning the big data. But after that, I just want to have more depth into the breast cancer. Like suppose I want to have those papers with regard to mammography. So I just click on mammography and it will give me the best papers with regard to big data, mammography, as well as breast cancer. So this is having machine learning and neural networks. So with this, you can find the best literature in order to find the search paper. If you want to search the papers, you want to find the literature. So you can go for these type of tools. So I hope everybody, you can now understand and give a new thinking to your brain now that in order to search the papers, don't only go to Google Scholar. Google Scholar will give you the whole of the word, but it is not clustered. It is not categorized. These tools will give you better parameters and better hold over your research. So now, everybody, I would like to give you another thing. So please be careful, but I will be listing you one surprise today. So how to find some predatory journal. So in order to find a predatory journal, I would like to give one website that is called beelslist.net. So if you find all these journals, all the journals that are covered over in this list are all predatory journals. So if you are searching for any journal, if you are not sure about any journal, whether it's a predatory journal or not, so just come to this one that is called beelslist.net. So this list always gets updated, but I'm very sorry to inform you that most of the journals are oriented from India only. So you can find lots of Indian journals over here that are actually coming under predatory. So all these journals like IARIA, IASET, International ASET, IAJC, ISIR. So all these type of journals are coming under the predatory journals. So be very careful when you submit your paper. So the second journals which I would like to give you, the next website is called Predatory Journals. Very important website for all of you. Please note it down. So all the list of predatory journals that are already updated daily, it gets updated. Even today, it has updated with 50 more journals, and 23 are now coming from Turkey and 12 are coming from China, which are now blacklisted now. So all the journals which are having these type of information with regard to the predatory information, you can find from this website. So this is the ultimate website to find the predatory journals. Okay. Now I would like to give you another website, which is very important for you to understand. That is called Retraction Watch. Now, if suppose like there are some papers which are getting retracted means that The papers are getting published, but after that, many people complained it because we have already seen that some Indian papers were being out from the journals of Nature, 59 impact factor and 71 impact factor, but now they are not longer activated on Springer Nature journals. So there is one website which can keep you updated with regard to Retraction Watch and all those people who are giving fake results in the world. So this website exposed many people. It's called retractionwatch.com. So be a close watch over here. You can see over here. So cancer surgery group in China may lose second paper. So this is, again, you can say from BMC, and all these authors are being listed over here, and they are getting the retraction of their 2018 paper. So you can see, even you can see there over here, journal editor breaks protocol to thank an anonymous whistleblower. So all the fake papers that is happening all over the world. So even you can say they have even retracted these papers of a radiology journal from this person, from Fukuyama nuclear disaster in Japan. So all these things are getting out from this type of website. So please take a quick note that if there is any black news that are coming from whole of the world, you will get the information easily. Now I would like to give you some better information with regard to the world. So many people say that if you want to do the research, if you want to write some research paper, so you have only two software that is called Grammarly, or you can have that is called your Ginger. But what is the problem with Grammarly? Grammarly can give you the English editing, but it will not give you the better sense in order to write into technical terms. And Ginger doesn't go for paragraph-based search. It just go line by line, which means that if you have a past tense, it will go for past tense. If you have a future tense, it will go for future tense. But there is one software which I would like to give you that is not only helpful in scientific writing, but will also improve the style in order to present your papers, which means that if you have a plagiarized content also, you can even update your language like that. So many people will say RefNSeek, but RefNSeek will not give you better quality. So I'm going to review this tool now. This is again free of cost, and you can download it on Google Chrome. You can even purchase it. It's a pro version. It's very cheap as compared to Grammarly. It's called prowritingaid.com. So this is another tool that you can use, a grammar checker, a style editor, and even the writing mentor. So it is, again, it is almost free of cost, and you can use this tool in order to write the emails, and it will improve your vocabulary. It can improve your scientific writing. It is recommended for sciences. It is recommended for computer science, but we don't recommend for those journals which are having more mathematics, like physics, mathematics, because they are more into mathematics. But if you are more towards writing a review paper or some writing a journal paper, or you're writing a basic conference paper, this is the particular website that you must use, that is called Pro Writing Age. Very important website and very important tool, research tool. Now I would like to give you one website. Yesterday I told you that many people say if you want to get connected with a research community, you need ResearchGate, you need LinkedIn, or you can even go to Facebook community. But there is one more website which I would like to tell you, that is actually known as the Facebook for researchers. So if you don't have this account over this website, but I feel that many of you will not have, but because it is not very old website, it is just a new platform, or I can say not very new platform. So this platform will provide you a great beginning to do the connections, to get meeting with your collaborators, and even with those people who are having the similar research interest with you. So this website is called sciprofiles.com. So if you don't have this account over here, so this is the best website, you can say a social network for researchers and scholars, and you can even find the relevant publications for conferences, and even you will love it to add your academic publications, everything over there. So the second thing which I would like all of you to please have this, it is called ORCID. ORCID ID is very important. And secondly, please make this account on Researcher ID. If you're working on this one, please add this Researcher ID into your platform. And one more important thing, please have your account on this website also, that is about.me. This is very good website in order to get connected. So these websites I would like to give you in order to start your good research. Now there is a problem in front of you that I've already told you yesterday, that every journal has its own audience. Even if you publish a SCA paper that, sir, I have published a SCA paper in Sensors Journal, but my paper was connected to solar energy. But every journal has its own audience. So similarly, if suppose you are a person of computer science and you want to publish a paper on data science, but it is not recommended that you can go towards a journal that is of image processing. But some journals even play like dumping, because they are open access journals, they publish anything. But in order to choose the best journal, which we already find, because even I am the editor in chief of smart vehicles and smart transportation, sometimes people try to submit the paper of image processing, and that becomes out of the scope. So I would like to give you one website through which you can suggest the journals, and you can get the list through which it matches your scope of writing, as well as it will suggest you where you should put your paper as per the good journals. So this website is called journalguide.com. So with this journal guide, you can just put your manuscript title. Like suppose I just put a dummy title, a novel methodology to improve security in cloud computing using blockchain. So suppose this is the title of the paper. And suppose if you want to add the abstract or you want to add some keywords over there, you can add over there. Like suppose if I write one line in this, in 20th century, it is important to improvise the security of cloud. Several mechanisms are available, but blockchain is treated as one of the best security orientations to improvise the security of cloud data centers. Like suppose if I write this line, and suppose if I click now on search, now with the power of artificial intelligence and with the power of natural language processing, this website will actually take your title and will take your abstract and will give you the suggestion that what is the best journal that you can put your paper in that. So please go over these journals, and you can see the three journals have come in front of me. One is called IEEE Cloud Computing. It is having impact factor of 1.866, very important journal. So second journal that has come is called Journal of Ambient Intelligence and IEEE Network. So according to this power of artificial intelligence and machine learning, this journal improves and improves. But I would like to suggest that you can add more information with regard to abstract so that it can search better for you and more journals can be provided. So this is the best website that you can find the journal, and it consists of all the databases. Now, the next website which I would like to give you suggestion, that is called from Springer. It's another tool from Springer. Very few people know. It's again called Journal Suggester. Like suppose if I do a title search like this, an improvised energy efficient routing protocol for sensor networks. Now suppose this is the title of my paper, and suppose if I give this title, wireless sensor networks play a crucial role in sensing, but face significant challenges with regard to energy. So it is important to propose a novel energy efficient routing protocol. Like suppose if I put these lines as a text of my manuscript text or some introduction text, or maybe I recommend you that you can copy paste your abstract. So I just select a subject area, and you can see all the subject areas are available, whether it is mathematics, whether it is philosophy, science, physics, anything, astrology, whatever it is. So I just click on computer science and I click on suggest journals. Now with the power of machine learning and AI, it will suggest me the journals. You can see Journal of Supercomputing, International Journal of Information Technology, Cluster Computing, Human Centric Computing, Computing Journal, MTAP, CSI Transaction. So you can find the impact factor and even the first days. So even if I want to refine my recommendations, so I just click on like minimum impact factor I need is 3, minimum acceptance rate I need 40%, and maximum time to decision I need 100 days. So with this, I can use the more selection. So if the journal matches, it is there. But if I change my parameters, you can find more journals. So you have to select the journal like that. So similarly, we have the tool for Elsevier. And similarly, you can use that is called your Taylor and Francis and other things. Now, I would like to give you, ladies and gentlemen, one of the most important tool, or I can say the website that you must use, and you must keep a close eye on this website. This is called Guide to Research. Now, let me tell you what is the magic behind this website. Now, watch carefully. Now, see this, everybody. Now, let me go towards a conference. Now, we have lots of websites called conference alerts, all conferences. I will be opening this website. Now, suppose I want to start with some specific conference. Okay. Like suppose if I click on all conferences now, now it will give me all the conferences. But suppose I want to make some search, which conference alerts in all conferences will not provide you. Like suppose if I just want to have a country that is India. Okay, suppose I want to have conference in India only, or suppose if I want to go to Japan, so I can click on Japan. Okay, so depend whatever the conference I want to go, first of all, select the country. So suppose if I have India and I want to have the publisher. Now, we know that there are lots of publishers in India for conferences, IEEE, ACM, Springer, Elsevier, DBLP, SPIE. There are lots of publishers. Now, suppose if I want to search only for Springer conferences, I just click on Springer now. So with this, it will give you the Springer conferences that are actually available. But I want to make it better, which means I just want to have those information, the upcoming conferences. Like suppose if I want to have the conferences which are coming in the month of January. So you can see that with the power of selection, we can able to select the specific conferences. And you can see one conference is coming in Bhubaneswar and one conference is coming in Pichanaur. So depending you whatever you want to have, you can use for this type of website from Guide to Search. But Guide to Search is having more powerful, is more powerful than that. So the biggest thing is that suppose if I am searching for a paper and I want to search a special issue, like there are lots of special issues in the world, but I want to have some specific special issue. Now I can click on special issues now. Now see what will happen. Like suppose if there is any special issue that is coming up, okay, like suppose in Elsevier, in Springer, I can even go for that one. Or even if you're organizing a special issue, please add your special issue in that because my three special issues are already approved. One is in 2 impact factor, one will be coming in 1.7 impact factor, and one is already in the final stages to get accepted in 6.4 impact factor. Okay, so once it will be available, I will be posting all those special issues on this website. Okay, so you can search that. So suppose if I want to have some specific, you can say a special issue, like suppose from Elsevier or anything, you can even modify that. And after that, if you suppose we want to have some conferences by the deadlines, all the top conferences, all the top journals with impact factor, you can search with that. So even you want to subscribe to newsletters or conference alerts, you can do with this because Guide to Research is one of the best websites in order to have reliability as compared to all conferences and conference alerts. This is one of the most important research tools that you can have. Now I would like to go for another tool that is called Mendeley. Now, I don't know how many people use it or not, but use it Mendeley because on this webinar, I would like to give you an important suggestion that Mendeley is one of the important tool. And even it is called a reference typecasting system, which you must all use if you are working on a reference, if you are using a review paper or if you're using for an experimental research. So don't use anything other like even we have Zotero, but Mendeley we personally recommend in order to have the better mapping of the research papers. So if you want, I can give you another session maybe next month or maybe at the end of this month that how to actually use Mendeley and how to get benefit from Mendeley. I can have special session. So depend on the coordinator, we can have that. So another tool which I would like to give you is, since it is not opening, let's wait for it. So suppose now we have a problem that suppose we are submitting our paper to Springer Nature. We are submitting our paper to IEEE Access. We are submitting the paper to those journals which we don't know what will be the pattern, what will be the presentation value. So there is one tool. You just have to upload your paper on that. You have to select the journal. And after that, in 5 minutes, with the power of machine learning and AI, this website will actually tweak your paper and will download the paper as per the format of that journal. So no need to type your journal, no need to type your paper again as per journal format. No need to retype your paper in LaTeX also. I will be telling you how to use LaTeX also. So there is one website called typeset.io. So typeset is the area you can see that it is smarter alternative to MS Word and LaTeX. So you can see that it is having more than 1 lakh verified journals. So putting our paper in that journal, which is not even known to this website. So you just have to sign up. And after that, you just have to upload your paper, select the journal. And in 5 minutes, you will get the paper downloaded as per that journal format. So no need to waste your time in journal editing and formatting. Now, the next website which I would like to available for all of you is called Literature and Lati/Seminar. This is again a site, you can say, in order to improve your writing in order to improve your vocabulary and in order to rephrase your sentence. So there is a problem that sometimes we type something and that the same line goes into plagiarism, like if you do for Turnitin or other things. So in order to rephrase that line, you can use this tool that is called Sevenair, and it is having the power of natural language processing with artificial intelligence, and this will improve your writing like anything. Okay, and again, it is like a free tool, but you can buy it, but it is not very expensive tool. So the next website which I would like to available all of you is called Kika.com. Another good website. So if you are going for any research paper, or you want to find any reference paper, or you want to link your paper that what other papers are available, like we have recommended articles or cached articles, you can use this type of website in order to perform reference manager, and you can annotate your bibliographies. So this is called the best website in order to search for the papers, and even you can download the PDFs, and even you can download it free of cost. Okay, so this is another website that you can use in order to search the papers and do that. Now, the next website which I would like to available all of you, many people say that if you want to go for download of any research paper in the world, you just use SCI Hub. We know it is SCI Hub. You can just download the paper with this, like any SCI paper. But if suppose any paper that is not available on SCI Hub, what you will do? So 90% people say that we must buy subscription. But I will tell you one more website, which is even dangerous than SCI Hub, and even it contains better papers as compared to SCI Hub. So the answer is called libgen.is. This is the most popular website. And over here, you can even download the ebooks from Wiley, Rocks, and even from IGI Global. So all those things that are not available on SCI Hub, you can be available on Library Genesis. That is called libgen.is. So I hope everybody is enjoying. Now, I would like to inform all of you that in order to do the research, it is very important that as compared to research papers, you must also download some of the thesis. You must research on the thesis. You must read some of the thesis. But today, after this research tool session, I will be opening up how to write the literature review, how to write the PhD thesis. I will be telling you everything. But in order to download the thesis, we all say that it is Shodh Ganga. Okay, but what if I tell you, you can even download the thesis of Shodh Ganga free of cost. Okay, so some of the thesis of Shodh Ganga, maybe they are available free of cost, maybe they are not available free of cost. But you can see there is one website which link whole of the world with regard to thesis, and it provides you the better search engine. It is called the Google of thesis search. So we use OATT.org, Open Access Thesis and Dissertations. Now, suppose because it is using, because this website is having big data, so this website will work slowly, but I will be telling you the beauty of this website. Like suppose if I'm researching on the area for blockchain again. So suppose if I want some thesis with regard to blockchain. So I just type blockchain and I click on search. So it will take some time because it is having the global database of all the thesis. So don't worry whether you are having a fast connection or a slow connection, it will take some time. So you can see that these are the theses that are coming with regard to blockchain. And you can see that you can even do the search as compared to the years. You can even go for departments. You can even go for master's and PhD thesis levels and even the languages. So this website will give you more hold towards searching of the thesis. And you can download every thesis free of cost. Very important. Now, the next website, which is even better than OATD, or I can say, which is having strong competition as compared to OATD, it's called openthesis.org. So this is another good website that you must use in order to refer the thesis, and you must download some of the thesis. The first important thing, if you started writing the thesis, it is better that you should refer some of the thesis, how the thesis are presented and how it is done. I will be also telling you one website. If you are doing your PhD and you want your thesis to be published, what to do. So I will be telling you. Just wait for some time. So meanwhile it opens, let me go to another website. Mr. Ashwin, I will be coming towards the question after 2 minutes, please. Thank you so much. So there is another website called ndnu.edu. So this is again an open access library for commons and private domains. So you can search for journals. You can see the list of the journals. You can search for books. You can see Academic Earth, free eBooks, Khan Academy, many books. So all the books that are available free of cost. But I click on thesis, you can just have access to more than 125,000 thesis and dissertation. So this is another best website that you can see in order to access the whole world at your fingertips. So this is important research tool. So now everybody, I would like to inform all of you that in order to publish your thesis, even I have published my thesis, I will be showing you my thesis right now. So there is one publisher that can publish your thesis. You just have to send them the PDF copy and they will go for a preliminary check for the thesis that everything is available. And after that, you can index your thesis into Google Scholar, ACM Digital Library, even DBLP. And your thesis will be given a DOI number and even the ISBN number. And everything is available free of cost. Within 10 days, they publish your thesis. So the answer is called Grin Publishers. So just go on this grin.com. This is a very good website. So maybe Open Thesis is not working right now, but you can just note the website and maybe after that it is working. So they are already updating the website. So please use this website. Okay, so this is, you can see, you can put your papers, you can put your master or bachelor thesis, you can even put your PhD thesis, whatever you want to have. Like suppose if you want to search my thesis is also available over here. So my thesis is a name called IEEMARP. This was my routing protocol. And you will be happy to know that till date from the last 4 years, this protocol is the number one protocol for swarm intelligence in sensor networks. None of the research scholars has made the result better than my protocol because my protocol is having the accuracy of 98.7%. That's the strongest protocol in the world right now. And it is not even implemented on NS2. It is also implemented in the real-time sensors. So that's the reason, everybody, my thesis was also what it as a best thesis about also. So you can see my thesis right now. So this is my thesis, everybody. Improvised energy efficient routing protocol based on ACO for sensor networks. So this was my thesis and you can download my entire thesis from my ResearchGate network. And I've already given you my ResearchGate. And if you want to follow me, you can just go to ResearchGate and you can search my name as Anand Nair. You can follow me and all my research is available over here and you can download my thesis, my articles, everything is available free of cost. And if you need any article to be done, you can just give me an access message. I will be sending you the paper immediately. Now, everybody, I would like to inform all of you that one more website, which is very, very good for you in order to improve your research skills. This is called skillyouneed.researchmethods.html. Very important website. So you can say that over here, you can find how to write a thesis, how to go for research methods, designing the research, interview for research, analyzing the data, multivariate analysis, anything, whatever you want to do, you can do with this. Now, everybody, I would like to take you to the journey of new things. Now we all know, let us find out the information with regard to the journal. Now many people say, sir, we go to Scopus. Now, if you want to go to Scopus, it is good, but let me tell you how to search a particular journal. Okay, so click on these sources. Now see everybody, right now, Scopus is having 41,317 results. Now see this. Now, let me tell you how to search for a good journal. Like suppose if I just want to go for subject area, or you can even go for title or publisher, depends on you, but I'm going for subject area. And I just click on my subject area that is called computer science. So here is the computer science. Or suppose if you want to go for like a signal processing software or computer networks, because my specialization is communications and deep learning, AI, blockchain, I work on everything. So I just click on computer science and I click on apply. But let me tell you, even this list will also have some predatory journals. I will be telling you about predatory journals later on this today's lecture. But you can see this 2,322 journals are available, which are indexed into Scopus. But let me tell you how to be safe side. Now see this, everybody, just go over here and you can see the first quartile and quartile two. So only publish in those journals that are only quarter one or quarter two. So I will be telling you what is quarter one and quarter two once I go to another website. So I just click on quarter one and quarter two, which means only the top journals, which are among the top 50% of the journals, which are safe, which means they will not be chunked out from the Scopus. And I click on apply. So you can see that these are the journals that you must use in order to index your papers. So these are the journals which I would like to recommend. And in order to get more information of the journal, many people say that, sir, we have MJL Claveret analysis. Okay, it is okay. But let me tell you what is the difference between Claveret and what we should not use on Claveret. Now, see this, everybody. Now, I'm giving you a practical demonstration. Suppose I want to search a journal that is called Journal of Supercomputing. See this. Now, Journal of Supercomputing, it's a Springer-oriented journal. I'm having three papers in this journal, regular issue. So it will give you this answer that is called ISSN number and the SCI index expanded, but it will not giving me any impact factor. It is not giving me the category. It is not giving me site score. It is giving me nothing. Although it is Web of Science website, but it is a very, you can say, weak website. But I would like to give you one more website that is better than this one. So the answer is called Letpub. So Letpub you must use in order to this one, Letpub. Better information we'll get. Now see this. You got this much information for supercomputing journal, but now see what I will going to get. Now see, I just put the journal name as Journal of Supercomputing. So it will auto with this search. Natural language. So I click on search and now see the magic will happen now. And I will, after that, I will tell you what, how to select the journal. First of all, understand. Right now, see this. It's giving me ISSN number, it is giving me journal name, it is giving me impact factor, it is giving me category that, okay, it is a category of engineering. It is not the category for other things. So you can go ahead with this. It is the index of SCI and SEI, no, easy, and ordinary, 3 to 6 weeks. It is good. So I just want to have more information. Now let me tell you how to get it. Now I click on this journal now. Now see this. This is Web of Science. It is nothing. But now see this, it is Letpub. It is giving you everything. Now see this, everybody. It is giving me site score. Now remember one thing, everybody, please understand me. Every year, impact factor changes. But some people say that impact factor is known as number of articles published divided by number of articles that are being cited or whatever the formula is. Okay, what the number, or you can say number of articles cited, sorry, the number of articles, how many times it is cited divided by number of articles that are published. And it will give you. But let me tell you, it is not the way that we must classify. Impact factor doesn't depend on this formula. It depends on this one also, the site score. And this site score gets updated every month. So if your site score of the journal, it is above 3. So make it sure it's internal information that I'm telling you. So if the site score of the journal is above 3 or it is touching above, it is increasing like anything, it is 100, no, it is a 500% chance that the impact factor of the journal will increase next year. And every year you have to improve your research impact, which means if 1 year back your research journal was having 1.7 impact factor, but today it has shooted to 4.6, which means your research impact is increasing because your impact every year it changes. So you can see it is having the quartile 2, quartile 1. So there are four types of quartiles, quartile 1, quartile 2, 3, and 4. So please work on quartile 1 and quartile 2. In the foreign universities, we only consider those SCA papers that are only published in quarter 1 and quarter 2. So you can find the self-citation ratio, you can find the publication, and even the linkages and everything. So you can see this is Letpub and this is Web of Science. So 90% people don't use this tool in order to search the journal in a better sense. Now I would like to inform all of you about some YouTube channels that you must use in order to get some better information in your life. Now just go to YouTube. Now in order to become the researcher, I would like to recommend you the number one channel, which is according to me is the best channel. And even this person who is running the channel is also the editor in chief of an Emerald journal. So I would like to suggest you the first channel is called Research Beast. This is one of the best channel that you can see. And you can see how to find research papers on Google Scholar, how to use case studies as a teaching method, what is literature view, how to find a research idea. So all the techniques or anything that is available on Research Beast. Now, some of the next channels which I would like to inform all of you is called Engadget. So these channels which I personally use in order to get informed with the technology. So please subscribe to these channels. Now, the next website which I would like to inform you is called TechBurner, one of the best presenter in terms of technology, latest, whatever it is coming, it gives you everything. Next is called MaxTech. Again, a very good, you can see that latest Apple has launched a new news called iMac. And even yesterday, Samsung has launched an event with regard to Samsung Galaxy Note 20, new earbuds, Samsung Watch 3, and even that is called your Samsung Galaxy Fold 2. So lots of things are happening. So you can see this one, 9 to 5 Mac, one of the best channel if you are working on iPhone. So what are the iPhone beta features, top iPhone top 10 sleeper features, whatever you want to have in terms of iPhone, iPad, AirPods, this is the perfect channel for you. Now, the next website channel I would like to request all of you is called TechVisor, one of the best channel in terms to get abreast with the technologies. The next channel I would like to inform all of you is called The Geek Pub. Very good website, very good, I can say, a channel that you can help you with in order to understand networking and communications in a practical manner. If you are good into, if you are interested to go for ethical hacking or you want to become a good ethical hacker, you can find everything on this channel that is called TechChip, one of the best hacking channels and my personal favorite also. So the next website, which I would like to inform all of you, and if you are into electronics and you want to do some projects with regard to IoT or embedded system, this is the channel that I would like to subscribe, novaspirit.tech. And even this person is also a good researcher. And even sometimes he gives us good tips and tricks how to improve your project. And this one next now is called Beboom, one of the best channels that you can see. And last but not the least, I personally suggest all of you that please subscribe to this channel. It's called Your Average Consumer. One of the best unboxings and everything in the world of tech is done by this guy. Now I would like to shift you to one of the most important website that can give you the whole world in your computer. Whatever you want to have, whatever torrent you want to have, whatever tutorials you want to have, ebooks you want to have, software you want to have, movies you want to have, you can go onto this website. But before that, I would like to suggest that you please download this this software into your computer. It's called uTorrent. Just download this software. You can download it on your Mac, on your Windows, everywhere. So after that, I would like to suggest one thing. So please listen carefully. Now see this. Now go to KickAss. Now search KickAss first of all. Now you will find lots of websites over here. Don't go to these websites. The first website is called the kickasstorrents.to. So this is the one website. So just click on this HTTPS kickasstorrents.to. Just click over here. And now suppose if you want to find some tutorials with regard to machine learning, mathematics, Python, or anything, whatever you want to have, just click on browse and click on. Ebooks and magazines are available every day. And if you search more, you can find tutorials over here. So let me find some tutorials. If I get the link, just I have to crawl more because here. Enhancing, yeah. So you can say that I just click on tons of tutorials of cost. And after that, I will tell you how to download the tutorials. You can see over here, right? You can see a new pages that have come. Vue.js, if you want to Vue.js. Even if you want on research methodology, you can search over here. Anything, whatever you want to have. Okay. Just let me give you some more things. Okay, just wait. Okay, so you can. And the art of massage. Learn Java. So suppose if you want. Happen. Then I will tell you what to do. Okay, now you don't have to download this one, or you don't have to click on this. Don't click on these two things. It will ask you for the payment. Okay, so just click on this one. That is called the magnet. You can see over here, there is a magnet link. Okay, just click on this magnet. And you will find an option over here because I'm using MacBook. So it will just use BitTorrent web. So I just click over here. And in just 10 seconds, it will just take some time. And in order to retrieve the file details in your computer, if you have installed uTorrent, it will automatically take you over there. Okay. So it will just take some time in order to retrieve the file details. And once it is done, you can just click on add and it will start downloading. So depending on the cedars, peers, it will give you everything. So this is how the whole world comes in front of you. You can even download MATLAB. So suppose if I just give a query called MATLAB, you can download the softwares, you can download anything. You can find all the softwares, you can find all the video tutorials, how to learn MATLAB, the tutorials, ebooks, whatever you want to have, you can download. So you can see this has come. So you can click on add and it will start downloading the torrent like instantly. So this is how we use the torrents, and this is how you can use. Okay, so this is how we can use anything over there. Yes, KCast will work through torrent, uTorrent. So this is all in terms of most important thing. And one more thing I would like to inform all of you. If you are going for a patent search, so just search the patent from here. This is the perfect website to search the patent. Okay, so if you want to file a patent, so many of the attorneys will charge you for the patent. So even they use this website for searching the patent. So just use this website in order to search. So this contains all the databases with regard to USPTO, ASPACET, the lens, Google patent search, PAT to PDF, patent scope. So if you are filing any patent and you want to file a US patent or a Chinese patent or a Korean patent or a Japanese patent, even an Indian patent, you can use this website to search for the patent. So this completes the lecture number one. So I hope everybody is enjoying. So the house is open for 2 minutes for the questions. And after that, I will be starting with this lecture in which I will be telling you how to write a literature review. And you can see this is, I have made my own notes. I am not using any presentation. I will be telling you how to write a literature review. And then whatever you are waiting for, how to write a thesis and dissertation. Okay, so there is no need to worry. I will be putting many things today. Okay, so meanwhile, if you have any question, please give me those questions. Thank you. Rupa ma'am?
Due to some technical issue, ma'am cannot be joined. So you can take the questions, sir.
Okay, no problem. Yeah, how to access Nature paper, I have already told you. You can go to Sci-Hub or you can even go for LibGen. So just search the DOI number of that paper and you will be able to download the paper free of cost. If you're working on LaTeX, so there is one tool called Overleaf you can use, but otherwise you can use TypeSet. It can even types out the paper as per LaTeX also. Yes, I will be telling you one important thing that is called mathematical equation. Apart from math type, you can use Mathematica. So even you can use a mathematical equation editor in Word that we use. So other things that can be used in that only. But I am giving you two more tools now after this break for 1 minute in which you can just ask your questions. I will just take a break for 1 minute because we have lots of things to cover. So we have to go for that.
Hello, sir.
Copyright issues with respect to these downloads, I don't think so. There is any copyright issue because I'm using these websites from the last 7 to 8 years. I didn't face any copyright issue or neither these websites have any problem. Yes, the person who wants to ask the question, they can unmute themselves.
Hello, sir. I want to ask a question. Hello, sir.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Sir, please go ahead.
Basically from the agriculture science student. So can I publish my agriculture related thesis in the green publisher, sir? Green.com.
First of all, I don't say because I'm a person of computer science. I don't know about the green publishers, but before you should publish your paper or thesis, it is better that you can check it from the Beals list that whether it is coming under predatory or not. So after checking the predatory list or not, so then you can decide that it is there. But otherwise, if you want to publish your thesis, it is better that you can publish with GRIN. I recommend you.
Can you show practically how to change the change to the journal format in the TypeSet.in website?
What? I don't understand.
Sir, I want to say, can you show practically how to change to the journal format in the TypeSet.in website?
Madam, I will be, because madam, we have a limited time, so I cannot demonstrate every website. So the main thing is that we have to proceed further, but you can just have to sign up. And after that, you can just upload your paper in Word file and select the journal, and then you can able to download your paper from that.
Sir, can every type of journal will be found in this type of website?
Almost 100,000 journals are there because I'm a man of computer science. So almost my 99% journals are available in that.
Only in engineering related journal will be found or other fields?
Madam, I have already told you that you are an agriculture science student and I'm a computer science person. So you have to check your journals.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you,
You
sir.
have to check your journals. So my question has come to you that while publishing papers is paid or open access journals are good. So it is better that you can go for the free journals first of all. And if there is any problem that your paper is not getting proper good review comments or other things, then you can go for paid journals. But sometimes paid journals or open access journals, they're having equal value. What are the best ways or techniques to do the literature view? I will be telling you right now. I will be telling you practically. So, sir, please suggest how to keep notes of the article that we use every day. So in order to keep the notes, whatever I use sticky notes, and even I use that is called Notepad plus plus editor in order to take the notes. But it is better that you can use sticky notes or you can use some Japanese stationery in order to keep the perfect notes for you. Any other question, everybody? Yeah, I will be telling you how to take notes of the article that we read daily, because there is a tech to read the paper also. You don't have to go for the complete reading. I will be telling you. Okay. So we start in 1 minute. Please hurry up for if there is any question from all of you. GitHub. GitHub is the perfect website to find the MATLAB programs. And you can give me one email. I will be giving you my email and WhatsApp after the end of this session. So after that, you can give me one email that, sir, please give us some websites where we can find the MATLAB programs. So I will be telling you 2-3 websites, but right now I don't remember right now. Okay, everybody, let's start now. Now, the most important question for all of you. What is literature review? But we all say that there are, after introduction, we say, because why I'm going to discuss literature review, because write it down, please, that if you want to write any paper, and if you want to write any Scopus paper or SCA paper, I'm not talking of conferences today, because in the today's conference world, if it is not necessary, if the conference is of Springer or IEEE and the pages are about 6 to 7 pages, so it is not necessary that you should put your literature view in that. So literature view, if you are putting your papers today in from this year onwards, it is recommended optionally that you can add the literature view, or you want to add or you don't want to add, but it will not be classified in the conference papers. But in the world of Scopus journals, in the world of SCA journals, literature view addition is very important. I've already told you. So if you are on the Scopus journals, I would like to suggest you that at least 10 to 15 papers should be taken as a baseline research. More can be better, but minimum 10 to 15 papers. But if you're going for SCA journals, I would like to suggest you that at least 15 to 25 papers should be there under the literature view or related works category to promote that what is being researched from your side. Now, before I should go for the how to write the literature view, I would like to give you 3 more tips. The first important tip, literature view should be only from the maximum last 6 years. Suppose we are in 20, please don't disturb. So suppose we are in 2020 right now. So please try to avoid those papers which are having the year that is 2012 or 2013. Try to stick to the papers which are less than 6 years, which means in 2020, try to use those papers from 2014 onwards. And I've already told you the tools for searching, and you can use those tools in order to search the better literature review for you, because the older literature view can put a question to your paper that maybe the other person has done the other works in that. So your literature view, more it is latest, it is giving the reviewer the better chance that, okay, he can see the proposed methodology and he will be confident enough that, okay, your paper can be go for revisions or acceptance. Most important. And the third most important thing that the people try to give mistakes in that after literature review, some people say that we have found this thing and now we are proposing these things in that. in the paper. So please don't make this mistake. After literature review, when you have done the literature review, I will be telling you how to do that. Yesterday, I've also told you. So please write in 9 to 10 lines what is actually the technical gaps that you have found that are actually being not researched out, or what are the problems that you have observed in the existing works that has led to design of your proposed methodology. Okay, so don't add those lines that, okay, in our chapter now we are giving this solution. Okay, we have proposed our new things on that. This is not literature review. Literature review means that section that is already known, that is already published. Okay, so don't add your own work in literature review. Okay, so this is the three important tips that the people don't follow in the literature review. Now, let me tell you what is meant by literature review. Literature review means it's a section that is actually being researched out. Now, suppose if I today tell you that, okay, let's work on sensor networks and let's find some security routing algorithm, or I can say, let's make a secure routing protocol. Or suppose if I'm working on cloud computing, let us improve the security of cloud. So in terms of literature view, you have to find some background that what is being done and what are the latest experimentation that has been proposed by other researchers. So basically, when you search the papers, and I've already given you the tools for search engines, how to find the search papers. So which means if I'm searching some particular thing like author mapper, I'm basically searching the published work. So that published work I'm going to read and I'm going to express in the papers that, okay, sir, we have taken this paper as a base paper. This has been proposed by this. This has been proposed by this. And now I'm basing the paper on this, on these bases. So the most important thing is the book reviews. So book review, what is the book review? Like suppose on Amazon, if suppose you want to do some critical comments that, okay, sir, we have done the review of this book. Okay, sir, the book is okay, but this thing or this section needs improvement, or this could have been added to the second edition. This means that you're putting your opinion that what you have liked or what you don't have liked in this book. So even suppose you buy this pen or you buy this Logitech mouse, you do the review that, okay, how this Logitech mouse is better in terms of battery, in terms of precision, in terms of accuracy, in terms of LED lights. So with this type of review, Logitech came to know that whether my product is okay or whether my product is not okay. So how I can improve my product with next version 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. Second is called annotated bibliography, which means all those sources that express your significance for the research. But let me tell you, in terms of your research papers, we only go for literature review. So don't write related works. Please write literature review as the best thing. And there is one word, one more word that people confuses in this literature view is called related terminologies. Now, suppose if I'm proposing something and if I'm using some base ground as a study, like, okay, sir, there is one algorithm which has been proposed by author A. There is one algorithm that is proposed by author B. And I'm the third author that is actually combining both the algorithms and I'm producing the C with the addition of these. So in that paper, you can add algorithm one and algorithm two as related terminologies, which means those terms which are need to be understood by the author to understand your rework. So don't confuse related works with the literature view. Related works means add on knowledge that is people require in order to understand your paper before after reading those terminologies. So why literature view, everybody? So the most important thing is that we have to write our topic. We have to find the base ground of the study. We have to find the relationships of the contributions. So basically, some people ask me that, sir, we want to find some technical gaps. How to do that? I will be telling you after this lecture, after this component, how to read the research paper. Because even if suppose I tell you that, okay, let's download some of the papers with regard to security in cloud computing. Let me tell you, you can find 16,000 papers. You have already seen the search, but not every paper is important for you. Not every paper is crucial to be done. So how to read the paper? What are the steps to have the three-pass approach? I will be telling you after this. So the most important thing is why we should write a literature review. The first thing is we have to mention that what are the problems with existing works? What is the contribution that is already being done? What are the technical gaps that are being discovered? And those unanswered questions or some more things that need to be improved in that particular area. And that is the reason I've told you that if you see my thesis, I've written research gaps in proper manner that, okay, sir, we have some routing protocols that are energy efficient, but some protocols have the problem of security. Some of the protocols have the problem with regard to packet delivery ratio, some problems with regard to acknowledgement. So which means those problems are to be understood. And these problems will give you the baseline study that, okay, sir, now I want to make this protocol and I will add these features that are not available in the previous protocol. So with this, we can able to understand that how to perform the literature review. So these are the three most important steps that are available. So the first thing is called research to find out what is written in the topic. I will be telling you how to do the research for that. And after that, you have to evaluate that, okay, sir, this is being proposed. This was the novelty in the work. And these are the contributions or the experimentations that are being done by the researcher. So let me tell you, some of the people, they make the mistake that, okay, sir, they just add the name Khan et al. Proposed this protocol. And after that, it is just like silence. No, if he just proposed a protocol, what is the novelty of that protocol? And what are the experimentations that he has concluded so that you can understand what is being proposed and what is the work actually done? And now you will take this work as the base in order to improve your work. So read with a purpose and system and do the key issues and themes properly. And for that, you need to understand. So in order to write the literature review, the most important thing is to understand the introduction section. So let me tell you, if you want to write a literature review of a particular paper, you don't have to read anything inside the paper, like what is read in introduction, what is being done by research design or other things. Just read the conclusion and just read the abstract. So if you read these two components, abstract and conclusion, you will be able to find what is being proposed by the researcher. And that technique is going to act as a base in order to understand. No doubt you have to read the paper, but for finding the literature view for your paper, only read the conclusion and abstract. And after that, you can write the body. What are the sources that are being addressed? What are the experimentations that are being conducted? And after that, in 9 to 10 lines, please write after literature view, what are the gaps that are being observed? So the most important thing is we have to find the summary of your findings from the literature review. Most important, everybody, and explain what is your analysis that conclude your overall state of the literature. So what is lagging, what is being proposed, and what is the research that is actually required? So that is what you are going to propose in your paper. So that is what you have to make your system model. And then I will be telling you more things about this work. So that is the brief introduction about literature review. Now I just come to important aspect for the seminar today. That is how to read the research paper. This is very, very important, everybody. And 90% people say that, sir, we have 100 papers, but even we are not able to understand the paper. So please understand this presentation very, very carefully. Please keep your eyes open and please note down my important points. The first and important thing, if you say that, sir, I have downloaded 100 papers and you have started reading the full complete paper, let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, you are making the biggest mistake of your life. You will not be able to understand anything. You will not understand anything for literature. You will not be able to make up anything for the paper. So before you start the research, let me tell you, everybody, the most important thing is to read one book, at least one book in your life. That is complete book that can give you the complete overview. And I've already told you pdfdrive.com, which is the best website that you can do in order to crawl some of the books. Read the content and after that, read at least 5 more books for that area in which you want to research. Like suppose if you are working on cloud computing, so you can read one important book from Rajkumar Bhaiya, which is known as Handbook of Cloud Computing, so that you can understand the entire information from history head to heart about cloud computing. And after that, you can take 5 more books from Springer, Elsevier, that, sir, I want to do research into security. So don't read the entire books, read the security part so that you can be able to understand more and more information, because it is the security only that you will be going to work. Because more understanding, better understanding. So now let us talk of how to read a research paper. And let me tell you, the information that you're going to get right now, it is actually my own work, which means I have made this approach. And from this approach, I was able to do my PhD in less than 4 years. I have submitted my PhD thesis in 3 years. Everybody, I have enrolled my PhD in April 2017 and in April 2014, I have enrolled my PhD. And on October 2017, I completed my PhD. Okay, so you can say that in just 3.5 years, I have just completed my entire PhD. So the question is, we have got hundreds of papers. We have got hundreds of literature. How to read the research paper. Most important, we have a 3-pass approach. Understand carefully. So in this presentation, we will be discussing what is introduction, what is the purpose of reading the paper, the three pass approach, resources for improving reading the research paper, and after that I will be giving you some recommendations. Okay, most important, yesterday I have given you some books, how to read a research paper, how to publish a scientific paper. It is very important to please read the two chapters for that books. Okay, so those people who have not understood my yesterday lecture, you will find some problems today. So don't worry, if you have a recording of that yesterday's lecture, you can use that. Otherwise, you can do my YouTube channel search. Lots of technical lectures are there already on that. So the first important thing, the most important thing in the PhD, we all say that, sir, researchers just want to read the paper. No, it is not only the paper that you have to read. You can read your white paper. You can read the books also. You can read your thesis also. You can read anything. Okay, you can even watch YouTube videos in order to make yourself understand what is the conceptual methodology. Okay, so the most important thing is to understand the concept. Only then you'll be able to improve that concept. So researchers spend lots of time about reading the papers. Selecting the appropriate research paper is an art. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, when I started my research on sensor networks, about 5,000 papers were available. And you will be stunned to note, with my approach, I was able to shortlist 128 research papers that were actually required. And those papers that are being read, that has to be read. And from that, I have done my PhD. And today, with this lecture, after this lecture, you will be able to understand that people say me problems. Sir, we have published our paper in 4 impact factor, but still the paper is not getting even 20 citations after 7 months. Sir, we have published our paper in 5 impact factor. The paper is good. The paper is latest, but still it is not getting citations, because the problem is you have not given the researcher a particular 3-pass approach. And the researcher has not taken your paper or shortlisted your paper to be cited. Okay. So the skill is very rarely taught. Very rarely. Everybody, you are lucky today that you are getting this skill taught, because it can even now lead to your less wastage of effort. Sometimes even it's a very funny answer I would like to tell you. About 6 months back, I got a call from a girl, and she was crying on the call. And she was telling me that, sir, I just learned from internet that you are one of the best persons in sensor networks. I'm researching in sensor networks from the last 4 years, and I don't know what is to be done and what is going to happen to me. I said, just send me your thesis, and after that, you give me a video call. I read her the synopsis. I told her, send me the synopsis and let me see your synopsis. I read her synopsis, and the synopsis was almost incorrect. Yes, everybody, it was incorrect. I don't know whether that guide was a foolish person, or whether that guide and on what conditions his guide was given the degree. I don't understand. If I would be the vice chancellor of that university, I would have shunted out that professor from the university. So what happened? She claimed some parameters that, okay, I will add these things. I will add these things. But after 4 years, what incident I told to her, her blood was going from here, this side, and blood was going like this side. Her entire face was like red. When I told her that the simulator that you are claiming, and even the research parameter that you are claiming, it is not possible, because the baseline protocol cannot provide you this parameter, which is your heart. You have not done your research work. And secondly, you claimed that you will do this protocol work or the design work of sensor networks into NS2, but NS2 has no capability. Your work is in Omnet++. And after 4 years, she came to know that she was on the wrong direction. And after that, I guided her properly. And in 7 months, she was able to put her train on the track that what she has to do. So the most important thing is that if you don't read the research paper correctly, and you just keep on crawling the research papers like anything, that, okay, sir, I have 30 papers, I have 50 papers. Maybe I can say justify that why this paper is justified for you. So maybe you are leading your wastage towards the efforts. So please read this information very carefully now. So what is the purpose of reading the paper? Very important. You should read the paper because you want to write the paper. Second, you want to present the paper in conference. You want to publish a paper in SCA journal, and you have to be updated what is being done and what needs to be done. So I am already telling you, keep on having the latest papers. That is the reason I have told you, don't search Google Scholar, search these tools, because these tools will help you to find the best research paper. So now this is the approach, everybody. I will be discussing the 3-pass approach. This is the approach that I actually invented when I was doing my PhD. Even I can say before my PhD, my guide was telling me that you are almost a PhD because you have done so much of work and you even have proposed the techniques to how to do a particular research work. Even before my PhD, I was giving the lectures of research methodology. Even during my PhD, I was giving the lectures on research methodology. Okay. So let us understand the first pass, the second pass, and the third pass. And after that, you will be all stunned to know that you are all putting your papers almost, if you have published the paper in SCI and your paper is not getting the citations, the paper is not correct. Yes, getting the SCI paper is different thing. Getting a cited paper and getting a recognized paper is different thing. Okay, so let us talk of the first pass, second pass, and the third pass. So suppose you have taken one paper. Now let me tell you how to read. Now the first pass. Now understand carefully, everybody. Now this applies to the whole of the research, whole of the world. Whether you are doing any type of research, you can use this approach. This is my research. Now the first pass, you just have to take 5 to 10 minutes to read that paper. Now you don't have to read the paper. Everybody, please understand, don't read the complete paper. Paper should be chunked out with this approach is that, okay, sir, we have 100 papers, which means every 100 paper should be given a first pass approach. After the first pass approach, you will be able to understand which paper will go to second pass. After second pass, all those papers that are in the third pass will be your literature review, will be your those papers that you actually require. Now see this. Now the first pass will take about 5 to 10 minutes and it consists of following steps. Now the first step, read the title first. Now, very important, because sometimes the person has done a great work. Okay, great work, I can say, but he has not given the name to his protocol. Even today, I got 2 papers to do the review in 2 journals. One is IEEE-XS and one is Multimeter Tools and Application. I've just given a major revision and even have told him, please resubmit the paper again. I will not do the review of the paper right now. I told him revisions are required and resubmit the paper for review. Okay, he has told that, okay, sir, a novel routing protocol for improving energy in sensor networks. What is this? What is the name of your protocol? And after the another technique is called like a novel blockchain mechanism for improving data center security. What is this blockchain? What is the title? You should give something name to your proposed methodology. So see this, carefully read the title. If your title is not good, what you will do to propose? So even in my PhD, I got 3 more good protocols, which I want to compare, but I don't want to use their names like Khan et al, like proposed approach or other approach on this one. No, I just want a clear names. Like, okay, I'm proposing a protocol called IEEMARP, which you have seen. And secondly, I'm comparing with AODV, DSTV, or other protocols that are having the name. So give the title very carefully. So after that, read the abstract and read the introduction. Just read these 3 things, first of all. Just read the first 3 things. And after that, just see what are the sections. Introduction, what are the section? Related works, system model, architecture. What are the headings of the section? Ignore everything. Just read the title, abstract, and introduction, and just read the section titles. Don't read any other section in the paper. After that, read the conclusion and just see the references, because those references are actually can act as a good game that, okay, sir, if he has proposed a protocol on these references, maybe I can use these references in order to propose my protocol better than that, my research better than that. So please glance over references. So in the first approach, go for title, go for abstract, go for introduction, go for sections, and go for conclusion and references. After that, you will be able to know that whether that paper is okay or whether you should leave the paper and you should move ahead with the second paper. So if the title, abstract, and conclusion matches to your area, that okay, sir, I'm working on security and this paper is matching to my scope of research, actually, this is my paper. Now, this will be giving you the category, what type of paper it is, whether it's a measurement paper or whether it's a review paper or whether it's an analysis paper or whether it's a proposed methodology. So we should do the analysis of existing system or whether it is a description of a prototype. So you must go for these type of questions. Okay, just when you read the paper, just put over there, okay, review paper number one. After that, analysis paper, measurement paper, analytical paper, novel proposed protocol. So give the classification to these papers. Okay, put a sticky note and you should write first pass, pass. And after that, what is the conclusion? What you have given that, okay, sir, is this a measurement paper? Is this a review paper? Make the different heads. And that's the reason everybody, I have told you that when I was doing my PhD, I have done my thesis in only 17 days. because I was having a strong base and classification of my research. Now, after this, you will be able to understand what other papers is related to and what is the theoretical base. So just read abstract, title, introduction, conclusion, and just glance over the references and just glance over the titles. So if this paper passes, out of 100 papers, now you will agree that only 40, 45 or 50 papers will pass the first pass approach. The rest of the papers are dummy papers. They are not for your research. So thesis, after that, you should find the assumptions to be valid or not. Okay, sir, this paper is valid. This paper is not valid. Now, what are the main contributions? Now, see this. This is called literature. Now you should make the literature. Now, see this. Now, after that, take a pen, take a copy. And after that, you should write on this clear paper that, okay, sir, this is paper number one. And this is proposed by this. And this is what the assumptions are made. And this is the contribution by the paper. And that is what you can say, everybody. When you are searching for the papers, you have actually started writing number chapter number two. Your thesis one chapter gets completed once you are able to make up those papers after three pass approach. And you will be stunned to note, everybody, in just 17 days, I just took 5 days to just tune my thesis and 5 days to read and do the grammar and English editing. And I was able to complete my thesis like anything. That's all because I have put my thesis on a steady pace. So see this, after that, you must continue with the first pass that whether the papers are into your research category or whether it is not. So reading is learning. So this is your first pass. Now, after that, you shortlisted 24 papers or 50 papers. Now go for second pass. Now see this. The people make mistakes. Now see this. Look at the figures, look at the diagrams and look at illustrations. So many people, what they do, computer science people, and even I reject those papers today and we don't give them the revisions. They just put the graphs. Okay, sir, this is the graph number A. This is the graph number two, graph number three. No data, no analysis, no conclusions, no verification of results, nothing else. So if you are putting up an analytical paper, if you're putting up a result-oriented paper, and if you're making some diagrams, whether it is any diagram, if you're making some analytical charts that, okay, sir, this is the data, please on the graphs, please add the titles, tables for the data. So you can use these figures, illustrations on the second pass. In the second pass, read the paper with great care because this is going to be the shortlisting paper. Otherwise, you will make mistakes. And see this, pay special attention to the graphs. Very special attention. I will be telling you one service that you should buy in order to make the better graphs. And even diagrams also, I use that only. And after that, please show the results. See the conclusions that are whether it is statistically significant or not. So see this, everybody. Today, I see lots of papers in SCA journals, even in IEEE XS, MTAP, supercomputing, cluster computing, lots of Elsevier journals also. They have the graphs, but they don't have the data. How can I validate this graph? Whether this graph is accurate or not. How can I validate? I cannot, which means that paper cannot pass the second pass approach. Never. So remember to mark the references. So this is going to be the reference number one, reference number two, reference number three. So more you read the papers, more you learn about the papers, the better you're grasping the content. And that's how you actually do. So don't read the paper at the first go, read the paper in chunks, that what is being observed, what is being done. And you should understand with the notes that what is being happening in the research work. So reading the paper and writing the notes out of that paper, it's a particular art. And that's the important activity that you must do for 1 month minimum. And that can be done because you have tools in order to search the papers. And now you have the papers, you are making the notes, how much time you are saving. You are not wasting your effort. You are going in the right direction. So after that, if the paper is not understood at the first level, read the paper again. Read the subject matter. Go for experimental technique. You can even email the authors. Sometimes people also give me the email. Sir, you published the paper. Can you give me this answer? I love to give the answers. That's why in every day I can say everybody that maybe you will not believe or not, but it's a correct thing. Every day I receive more than 600 to 1700 emails every day. 600 to 1700 emails. And I reply to every email every day. So the paper can be poorly written. Because why? Because the English is not corrected. And that's the reason, everybody, that English is very important. Sometimes words, lines are not getting readable. Sometimes sections are missing. So these things. So you must keep the papers aside that whether you need to understand the material in your career or whether you cannot, or whether you can release the paper to the third pass or whether you want to delete those papers. So the third pass. Now, this is the main pass, everybody. Now, in this, I would like to say it openly. I will not use a slide. Just read what is being proposed. What is being proposed? Like, okay, neither proposed protocol, system model. I will be telling you how to write the paper. So read the proposed protocol or proposed methodology. Read the system model. What are the methodology that he has used? Because why? Now you are on the final stage that what the author has actually contributed. Now with more reading and learning, you are able to preparing yourself to understand what is happening in the paper. So this is the third pass approach that you must all follow in order to understand. Okay, so you can just after that, you can find that what is being proposed, what is the architecture, what is the drawbacks, what are the things that author plans to go for future work, and even the future work can be your technical gap, can be the objective. Okay, so let me tell you what is the difference between technical gaps and objective. So many people don't understand. So technical gaps are those that is the work that is not actually done by the existing authors, which means that is missing, that is not happened. And the future work or the objective is that the authors want to plan in the future or what you want to plan in order to solve the problems in the existing books. That will become your objective that, okay, sir, now I will make this pen better as compared to this pen by improving the grip, by improving the precision and better ink. So that's how this is called the existing literature that, okay, sir, this pen has a bad ink, this pen has a less grip, but these are the technical gaps. But this is my objective that I will improve the grip, I will improve the ink, I will improve better precision. So that is your objective. The main thing is the journey from here to here. So that's the answer, everybody. So in between, you have to read all the pens-based literature, what has happened and what is being happening. So that's what I want to give you in this lecture. So now we take a break for 5 minutes. After that, we will be starting with the next presentation, which is very important for you to understand, which is known as how to write a thesis or dissertation. I will be telling you about writing, that what is to be written in chapter one, chapter two, because people make lots of mistakes. And finally, after that, we will be going towards the much awaited lecture for all of you, which is known as this lecture. That is how to write an effective research paper and tips for acceptance. Please mute yourself, please. Okay. If there is any question, please ask. Now we have a break for 5 minutes. Thank you. And I will be completing the lecture in next 45 minutes. Any question, please? I hope you're all enjoying. Please write something. Okay. For writing a review paper, how many articles we need to take as a reference? I would like to tell you, this is an important thing that nobody will tell you. I'm going to give you an information that if you want to write a good paper, a review paper, I'm saying openly, if you are targeting an SCI journal, it is difficult to have a review paper, but there are texts to write a review paper. So the only references or the number that I'm going to give you is the reference. If you are using that type of number, it is most important. Now see this. Now, if you are writing a conference paper, 15 to 19 references are enough. 15 to 19, enough. IEEE, ACM, Springer, 15 to 19, enough. If you are writing a Scopus paper, 30 to 45, enough. Enough, I'm saying enough. If you are writing for chapter, like you are writing a chapter for CRC Press, Springer, or Elsevier, whatever it is, 50 to 75 references, enough. Enough. If you are writing a SCI paper in which you have done some conclusions, results, or anything with proposed methodology, not review paper, proposed work, everything, architecture, framework, 65 to 80 references, well enough. But if you are writing a review paper for a journal, SCI journal, or a Scopus journal, or anything, I recommend 90 to 125 references, minimum should be there. So that is the exact number that nobody will tell you. So please note down these numbers. I hope this clears your answer. Any other question, please? Actually, Komal Parekh, I would like to inform you. Yeah, I will be telling you the plagiarism. In India, I'm sorry to say, we are doing the PhD in a wrong sense. Why in a wrong sense? Let me tell you. If you come outside to India, who is doing PhD? If a professor who is having some grant, that's a real-time project where he is solving particular problem. Because what is PhD? It is actually solving a particular problem that has social impact. Okay, or a real-time problem solution. So if you want to solve that problem and you want to contribute towards solving a particular problem in which you have contributed something, that is your doctorate. And even for the postdoc, you are actually contributing with some project. But over here in India, we just enroll ourselves in a private university. We find a particular guide, not in our topic, etc. And after that, we start doing the literature. We just focus on two conferences or one Scopus paper, and we just do a simulation work. That is not a PhD. That is not a PhD, according to me. Okay. So if you are going for a plagiarism checker, let me tell you, I'm having one friend in Malaysia. If you want to write a better plagiarism software, it is Turnitin. But Turnitin, you all say that it is expensive. But if you want, I can give you the contact number of that person. You can just give me one email. And after that, you can contact that person. He can sell you the software of Turnitin with your own username and password. And you can do unlimited checks in instructor login. Don't buy the student login, buy the instructor login, unlimited. And it is less than 2000 rupees per annum. You can buy that Turnitin software. No problems. So free plagiarism software, we don't suggest. Not good. Sir, minimum and maximum, how many review of literature is required for PhD? Yes, that's a good question. So I would like to tell you one important numbers. Now see this number. Minimum two books, maximum seven books. Now please don't write anything in between. Just read this. Maximum seven books, only with focus on action topic. Action topic means in which you want to do. Just focus on those seven chapters. After that, 15 theses. 11 to 18 white papers, or I can say 20 to 30 blogs or websites, related websites. Now see this, what is going to happen for all of you. Now, minimum 20 to 22 review papers, 20 to 35 proposed works, and 10 papers, which nobody is going to tell you. Can anybody guess what are those 10 papers which you should actually do? That is known as performance comparison papers. So this is going to be the exact literature and references for your thesis. Very important. Now you can understand, everybody, how to actually do effective research. I'm not coming to research paper right now. I will be doing lots of things now. I will be covering hundreds of things after this lecture, after this break. But right now you are learning, I am saying openly. So I hope everybody is enjoying. Please give some feedback now. Maybe if I have the time, I will be giving you some research grant. Okay. Because actually my lecture is for 4 to 5 days. So actually, if you really want to enjoy the core research methodology, I give for 6 days. That is my core course that I have designed how to do PhD. Okay. Blog or websites? Now, this is an important question. So how to cite a website? Now, let me give you the answer. So the first of all, you just write the name of the website. What is the name of the website, or what is the main source of that website, or what you can say, what is being explained in the website. Then after that, you can write the web link. What is the web link? And in the bracket, please write accessed on 13th July 2020. This is how you cite the reference. So blogs can be okay, but don't don't cite Wikipedia. Okay? Yeah, actually, I'm a drone pilot, so actually, I do lots of works, everybody. Even I'm a professional black hat hacker, even after this lecture, even you will be stunned to note that I can speak for 3 days, I can speak for 5 days continuously. Okay, so my highest record is for speaking for 37 hours, which I've spoken continuously for drones, MATLAB, and Python. I do lots of work in Python and MATLAB programming, and even for drone programming also. I'm a professional drone pilot also. So depend on the coordinator, who is the coordinator, he can apply for 6 days course. Depending that if I'm free, I will go for that. Even I give the course for how to be effective teacher, how to go for pedagogy. Okay, so even I'm also working on how to become an effective teacher and pedagogical teacher and how to go for teaching aids. I just improve myself, because in our university, lots of people come and they improve our teaching, like all these things. So I've already given you the software that is called Turnitin. That Turnitin is the number one software. Okay. And after that, the most important software that you can, that most of the universities also use for checking the thesis only, that is called Urkund. Urkund is a software, but we don't recommend. Okay. But there is one more software, which is actually used by some of the journals that is over there, that you can see under the journal website. But we mostly use Turnitin. Or you can use one more software, but actually we have tried a lot that we can find some crack. We have even decided that there are some people who can sell it very cheap. But iThenticate, this is also a very popular software that most of the journals actually use in order to detect the plagiarism. So if you are a student and you want a perfect plagiarism software, you can use Turnitin. Okay, I'm using Turnitin of my own. I have almost everything in my lab. Okay. Coordinator, madam.
Yes, sir.
Rupa,
yes,
madam, sir. Have you joined?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Happened any problem?
Yes, sir. Network issues, sir. I'm staying outskirts of city, sir. It's okay. 25 kilometer far from this, near to village actually.
Okay. No problem.
Kindly do one thing, madam.
Okay, we can have a 3 days course after this lecture. After this course, we can have a 3 days course maybe next month in September, because August is my fitting time. We can have an effective course at how to become an effective teacher.
Okay, sir.
How to improve our teaching.
First week of September or second week?
We can plan. We can plan.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your cooperation.
Because even today, madam, teaching is an art for me. Even I improve my teaching every day. Okay. How to improve the teaching. Okay.
Okay, sir. Sorry,
but,
sir. Network problem.
I'm not able to. Madam, I'm saying that maybe some of the, you can say that some people will have some problems understanding my lecture of teaching, because my teaching is oriented towards management and computer science only. Okay.
So if the
students only enroll for management people, because I also teach management subjects here, because few people also know that even I'm also going to complete my third PhD. Actually, I'm a double PhD.
Congratulations.
I'm going to complete my two postdocs by the next year, actually.
Very nice, sir.
Actually, I don't go for my complete resume opening, because if I complete my own resume opening, so it will be a great panic in the whole world, I can say.
I just want to
say all of you that even most of the people, they can even make a mistake. Madam, even you can do one thing. You can organize my session on for 1 day for your students at how to make a resume, effective resume.
That is only for the students. Okay, thank you very much for
I know how to evaluate the resumes and what the resume should look like, and even don't have to type anything. You just have to give the data to the website, and after that you can effectively make your own resume. That website actually has neural networks in order to understand your resume, actually.
Oh, okay, sir. Very nice, sir. Thank you, sir, for giving so much.
That is only for the students only. That is only for.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, everybody.
I'm contacting through mail, sir, for you. September.
Yes, sure. No problem. But please take the feedback from the participants today. I hope they're all enjoying. I think so.
Yeah, definitely, sir.
Yeah.
Yesterday also we taken, sir.
I will be sharing my email ID, my WhatsApp number after the session, so don't need to worry. Okay. Yeah, sure. Madam, please plan the resume session this month only.
Okay, sir.
How to make an effective resume, I will be telling you. And even you can give me any resume. I will be taking that resume and I will be putting that how to make it a powerful resume. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
thank you, sir.
Students, the resumes will be looking better in your resume. Very better, I can say.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
So, yeah, it's okay, ma'am. Sorry, because actually my research lecture is for 2 days. I have already told you that my research lecture is for 5 or 6 days. So for the third or fourth day, I discussed that how to write a book chapter. So this lecture is only for research paper, basic foundation of research, research tools, analysis part, as well as thesis part. So I cannot discuss book chapter. Okay. So let us talk of the thesis and dissertation, everybody. Okay, now I will be not talking much detail about it because I would like to inform all of you that after 1 hour or maybe after 1.5 hour, I have to give my another lecture on cybersecurity, that is with hacking wireless communications. So because I'm a professional hacker, we always keep on updating our skills with regard to hacking. So madam, if you are also interested for having one lecture, practical lecture, that is how to hack wireless networks, I'm also interested for that.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
I will be telling you that how you can, even you will be surprised to note, madam, that we just take one dongle in our pocket and we just take a mobile phone and we can hack the entire city networks in just 10 minutes. We can hack that.
Okay, sir.
My fastest hacking time in the world, you can just see, if you can just see Google Scholar or Google also. My fastest hacking time is about 3 minutes and 44 seconds for to hack about 24 Wi-Fi connections.
Oh, very nice.
Because as an experienced black hat, I just keep on working on wireless communications. Okay, before I start my lecture with regard to the thesis, please, I would like to have silence now. Please, thank you so much. I would like to share with with all of you that if you can, that many people say me that, sir, how we should draw the diagrams, how we should draw the graphs, how we can make a powerful PowerPoint presentations, etc. But Soma, I would like to inform you that the LaTeX class happens on the fourth day of my lecture, because I can even make anybody a LaTeX expert in 2 hours. I can make them. But today it is a lecture for research methodology for 2 days. I'm totally very jam packed because every day I'm giving 4 to 5 webinars. My internal lectures are there. So I'm a busy person. So very few lectures I give. Okay. So I would like to inform all of you that many people ask me the question that, sir, what tool we should use? But I would like to inform you all that I have already given you this kick-ass website. So if you have Microsoft Office 2016, just download this software today. This is called MS Visio. I use this software, everybody, that is called Visio. So it's a part of Microsoft Office, but few people know that even this Visio is one of the powerful tools. But if you find that Visio is difficult for you to understand, I would like to inform you that if you can spend about 3,500 rupees, it is a one-time investment. I have already done it. You can buy this pack that is called Infographics. So if you go for this one, infographia.com, you can go for this package and you can find all the diagrams, all the graphs, whatever you want to have. So that's why you can see my papers in MDPI. Even MDPI that asked me sometimes that, sir, how you make the graphs. So after that, I told them that, sir, I use this type of diagrams. I use infographic in order to make presentation, the graphs, etc. Okay. So I use this tool in order to do the diagrams, but you can even download some of the free templates also. Okay. So I hope this makes the question clear. Now, I would like to inform all of you, please understand. Now, in order to do PhD, the most important thing is to understand your thesis. And I've already told you there are websites called OATD, Open Thesis, NCDLU. I have given you many websites through which you can download the thesis. And I personally suggest you also, all those who are doing their PhD in computer science, please download my thesis also, which is available on ResearchGate. And you can download it free of cost. It is open. And you just see how I manage my thesis. And it's a work for only 7 to 10 days. So the first question to all of you, what you should write in the chapters. So the first thing is, in the first chapter, that is known as introduction chapter, or you can say the purpose and significance of the study. Now, in the introduction, 90% people will fail. Now, I should start this lecture parallelly now, how to write the research paper. Now, in the introduction part, first of all, in the first two paragraphs, you should write what is the baseline of the study. Please start with with some data analytics, like according to Statistica, according to Gartner reports. If you add the latest data, you are actually giving the impression that, okay, sir, my research is the latest research. So the first two paragraphs should be the main area, like you're doing your area in cloud computing or bacteria or anything. Explain that area in the first two paragraphs. After that, define in the research paper what is the main area or the scope or the application that you are doing to research. Like suppose you are doing your research into sensor networks and you are doing your research into energy efficiency. So write your sensor networks in the first two paragraphs, and after that, add your energy based information to that. And in this, you can see in the first chapter, but I will be coming towards research paper after this presentation. So in the first chapter, clearly state what is the purpose of study and explain the study significance, how it is important. And after that, please understand, PhD students must explain how their research makes an original contribution to the body of knowledge. So which means that you have to write your research contributions, you have to write your research objectives and what is being proposed. And even let me tell you, in your first chapter, please also make a section that is known as papers published. Please add this section, because that is the purpose and significance, that how you have justified that this is the data that is being, or the research that you have taken care of, is important. So this is going to be the chapter number one for you. And chapter number one, you can even start writing, because let me tell you, I've already told you, if you have read one book and you have read five more books in order to make that study, you will always use that knowledge. Learning is knowledge in order to understand your chapter number one and chapter number two. So I've already told you, so the chapter number two will be your review of literature or literature view. So the first baseline study, I've already told you, with the three-pass approach. Pass one, I again repeat, pass one, please read title, abstract, introduction, conclusion, glance over the references and just read the headings. In second pass, read the figures, read the graphs and read the conclusions. Very, very important. And then the third pass, please read what is being contributed. So if you are able to understand these type of three passes, getting the literature view is not a big problem. So you can see that this chapter should not merely string towards what other researchers have found. You should discuss what you have analyzed, what you have analyzed, what are the technical gaps. So this determination will lead to your research questions. So let me tell you, what is research question? Your technical gaps. So what you have studied, what is the problem with existing works, is exactly becoming your research question, that, okay, sir, they have proposed five protocols. They have proposed some security, but security is lagging. Okay, sir, let's replace this security. Now we add blockchain. Okay, sir, let's replace this optimization technique. Let's add deep learning. So that's how you will be able to understand that these are the technical gaps that are actually being done. These are the shortcomings of the study. And now we want to propose these things. And that's why I'm saying you, research gaps identified should be added at the end of this chapter. Very important. Now the third important chapter, methodology. I'm going to tell you everybody, I have evaluated 15 theses in last 3 years. Not take the name of the university. It is, some of the universities are from North India. One university was from Israel, and some university of India, and two universities from Malaysia. And believe me, if you tell me that, sir, which thesis one thesis was from Australia. And if you tell me that, sir, which thesis or is the best thesis according to you, I say Australia, because the methodological presentation which they have done, how they presented their research work, that is actually the main aspect of it, and that's what the lags come when we evaluate the thesis from here. So the chapter three, everybody, most important, please listen to me very carefully. Now this chapter three actually is the chapter in which your work starts. What you have done last 3 to 5 years. This is your methodology. Now, let me tell you, don't confuse methodology with results. Methodology is the method that is being proposed. What is the technical specifications? How your steps are working, your flowchart, and even your algorithms. What is the technical information without? So see this, everybody. So this chapter will describe the data gathering method that you have used. But by describing the method you choose, the method is most appropriate. Most appropriate, I'm saying. So see this, everybody. You should first of all design the research design. What is the internal and what is the external validity? That, okay, sir, I have designed a system model and I am adding these components, mathematical components. I am describing the description of population and observation. What is the development of the method? How I tested the reliability. Okay, sir, I have tested mathematically. I have proposed these steps. I have added these novel things. This is my algorithm. So everything. And after that, you can even add the coding, but we don't recommend the coding. And after that, give the description. And today, after this presentation, I will be telling you one statistical tool, which you will be all stunned today. No need for SPSS. That tool is the most easy tool to perform everything. I will be telling you. So the most important thing is to categorize. What is the category of your research? So the most important thing is your methodology. And if you are a student of computer science, in this, please highlight how your proposed method is working. What is the steps of operation? What is the flowchart? What is the algorithm? And any other technical details that is associated towards it, which means your work needs to be explained. What is being done technically? What is the novel technique that you have done? And after that, you have to find your given, that is called findings. Now, this is called experimentation. Now, what simulator you have used? Real-time analytics. So please add your data sets. And please, one more thing, if you are using some new methodology and you're using some particular data set, that is not the thesis. We are even returning the thesis back now. Even I'm going to return one thesis back to Indian University. That, sir, this is just a data set that is being used. Okay, so I want that to add a real-time data, or you can say some primary data. So what is the simulator use? What is the data set use? What are the parameters? And what are the individual parameters that you have done, like throughput, efficiency, energy, or routing, whatever you have used in order to validate your work. Okay, and after that, this is called discussion. Now, this discussion will be the comparison. Now, see this, everybody. This is your proposed work. This is how you test your work. And now you have to validate your work. Now, again, I'm repeating everything. This is for your purpose of the study, the baseline. What is being researched? What is your application? And what are your objectives? And what are your research questions? Review of literature will give you the baseline study and what is the technical gaps that you have discussed. Methodology is your own proposed work highlighted technically. Then what are the findings? That is your experimentation, how you tested that. And what are the results in different parameters? And after that, you have to do the discussion. Discussion means you have to compare your proposed work with some existing works. Like you can see my thesis today, everybody, you will be stunned to note that 99% people, they compare their work with one or two works. But you can see my thesis, my work is compared with 11 works. Even I have published 5 SCA papers, 4 Scopus papers, 6 conference papers and 2 book chapters and 1 book I have written in during my PhD. Now I ask everybody, you can see my research work. You can see my scholar. One of the top papers in the world, the comprehensive paper and the best routing protocol till date from the last 4 years is with me. The most comprehensive. So with this discussion, you must compare that, okay, sir, I have compared this thing with these things and I'm able to do that. So after that, you should finish the research work by adding the conclusion. And after that, you can add your references and even your future scope. So that's how you can say these are the 5 important chapters for your thesis. Chapter number 1, purpose, introduction. Chapter 2, literature. Third chapter, methodology. Chapter number 4, findings or experimentation. Okay, or results and validation. And after 5, this is called discussion. And even you can add your more analysis that, okay, what we have done, what is being analyzed. So please add the data and add the graphs. And after that, please add your conclusion, references, sorry, conclusion, future scope and references. And I've already told you references, numbers, when you have seen your questions in the meetings. So that's all what I want to say in terms of PhD research. Now we will take a break for 5 minutes. And after that, I will be starting the biggest lecture that you are all waiting for, how to write an effective research paper and tips for acceptance. And ladies and gentlemen, I would like to give you this information, not as a research guide or as a trainer. I would like to give you the information as an editor in chief of a journal. Even you can see, I'm right now the associate editor for 6 Scopus journals, 2 SCA journals, And you can say, I'm going to get acceptance letter for 3 transaction journals by next year. I will be having the second in command for 2 transaction journals next year. Now, if you have any question, please give me the question now. Now the house is open. Okay, one question has come. How to differentiate introduction review of literature? Introduction means that you are giving the information with regard to the work or the area that you are working, as well as what is the area that you are going to research, as well as you have to write your objectives. After that, organization of the paper. And after that, this is called review of literature. Review of literature means what are the existing works that you have done. Okay, let me show you one important thing that I have. Everybody, please take the photo of this picture. I will be sharing this picture tomorrow to Dr. Rupa. Dr. Rupa?
Yes, sir.
Madam, share this picture.
Yes, sir.
Everybody, tomorrow. I will be telling you what is the exact literature or the exact English that we must use. Actually, I'm having 2 days. Otherwise, I just take one lecture of this one also. This is my own lecture, which I use. Introduction to scientific writing. So this is another lecture that I use, but this lecture will take 3 hours. So I cannot discuss this lecture. Okay, any other question, please? Thank you. Any other question, please? Hurry up. Madam, we will be finishing the lecture after 30 minutes. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. I hope we are on time.
Yes, sir.
Or we have delayed.
It's okay, sir.
Okay. Sir, I always have a confusion, abstract versus introduction. Can you elaborate? That is what I want to elaborate. Yeah. So don't worry, I will be telling you how to write abstract and what to write in abstract. Yeah, you just go to over there. You can see. I will be telling you. Just go to YouTube and just search my name. Okay. And you just click here. And after that, you just go to playlist. So you can find this, you can say playlist, my technical lectures in various institutions. So you can find all my lectures here, all the FDPs that I have given recently, everything, and even all the FDPs will be shared over here. So this is all my lectures that I have placed over here. Okay. And you can find all my hacking lectures, my NS2 lectures, everything is there. Please hurry up with one question or two questions. After that, I will start with my lecture for how to write a research paper. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Madam, plan the next lecture for resume writing.
Okay, sir.
And after that, we can plan the lecture for how to become effective teacher.
How to become effective teacher.
I'm not a civil engineer, everybody. Please, I'm thinking about that again. Please, I just work on computer science. I'm a man of computer science. Over here, there is 1010. That's all.
resume reading.
Resume writing and how to become effective teacher.
How to become effective teacher. 3 days, yes. That one. Resume writing 1 day.
Resume writing 1 day and effective teacher for 2 days.
Yes, 2 days. Okay, sir.
I will be telling you how to deliver the lecture.
Okay, sir.
Now, everybody, before I start my lecture, I would like all of you to kindly read this abstract. I'm giving this link to all of you. This is the regular paper in Springer in Multimeter Tools and Application. Just open this link in your computers and read the abstract. After that, we start the lecture. I give you 5 minutes. This research that you're going to read right now, you're reading the number one research paper in sensor communications oriented towards swarm intelligence. Read this paper. Whenever some papers come to me that, sir, we want to collaborate some paper with you, we don't know how to do the structure, I just send this paper to them. First of all, read this paper, read the structure, and then come to me. Okay. And if you can, I would like to request all of you, if you can go to my Google Scholar, read this paper, everybody. This is an IEEE access. This is this paper called Advancing Modern Healthcare with Nanotechnology. If you can open this paper in your computers, I have just told you that please read the abstract of the paper. I know it's a paid paper, but I will be giving you the paper, no problem. Just read the abstract. Whatever I say, just do that only. And all of my papers, if you can see on Google Scholar, they're all on regular issues. I don't use special issues. Okay. So the paper which I'm going to share right now, this is another link. Just read this paper also. And let me tell you about this paper. This is the world's biggest paper ever written on modern healthcare with nanotechnology, nanobiosensors.
Okay. Sir, excuse me, sir. Your screen is not sharing, sir. It's not visible. Oh, yes. Yes, sir.
Just wait, madam. I'm sharing the screen again. Now visible? Visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. So I'm sorry, this website will take some time, but meanwhile, we can start. Now, everybody, I would like to inform all of you, please leave your whole world and please focus on the presentation. Just listen to the listen to my words and please focus on the slides. Because in next 30 minutes, I'm granting you one thing. I guarantee you, whether your paper will come under major or minor revision. My voice is not coming, madam.
It's clear, sir. Voice is clear. But
some
sir.
People are saying that your voice is coming low. I think so. Their network connection is having the problem.
Because of the, but it's sometimes clear, sir.
Sometimes it becomes very funny because why? Because we people, we think of the dream that we will have autonomous technology. We will use cyber physical systems, but still our country is not having the proper connections with regard to mobile phones and even the internet. Controversial. Yes. Yeah, controversial, man. Controversial. Okay. No problem. Okay. So in the next 30 minutes, everybody, I would be telling you how to write a SCI paper, And what are the reasons that you will be all stunned to note that why the papers are getting rejected? Now, let me tell you, we will start with the first tip. Very important. The first impression for the editor-in-chief is three. Three things are being noted for your paper. Please write down these three things. The first thing is the scope of the paper is matching towards the scope of the journal or not. And I've already told you, journal finder tool. Please check the paper with the title and the keywords and then go towards that journal. The tip number one. The second, most important, is your abstract being information, is information confined, or whether your abstract is giving you the perfect information or not. So abstract is the second thing that is being checked. And the third and the most important thing, which whole of the world don't know, but we actually internally, I'm giving you this information, which is actually being used. The cover letter, along with that, your proposed work that is actually checked. The editor in chief never checks your literature view, never checks your result. He checks your abstract. He checks your proposed work. So, and even he checks the scope. And if he is okay with these three aspects, he will be able to through your paper to the reviewers. Otherwise, you just post the paper and in just 20 minutes, you will get the letter that the paper has been rejected because of the out of scope. Okay, so please make sure of these three things. And I've already given you the tools that will help you not to find these rejections at the desk. This is called desk reject. Okay, now let us come towards research paper now. How to write a research paper and the tips for acceptance. Very important. So where do we begin? Now consider everybody, please, if you want to, because I do Kung Fu and I'm a follower of Bruce Lee. And Bruce Lee always say that if you want to say your own words, you don't find a teacher, you get circled around. So free your knowledge, empty your knowledge, and then fill the glass over there. You will be able to understand what is happening. So consider that you have not written any paper. Now you are just a child. The more I'm thinking and better I'm getting confused. And that is the right way that you can come. And that's why research writing is like a Kung Fu in which you have to understand the opponent. And in order to defeat the opponent, you don't have to be stronger. You have to find the weak point and strike on that weak point. And that's the victory. So always remember the first way of Kung Fu is to not is to just defend yourself with the power of strength. And you have to identify the weakness of the opponent. And the weakness of opponent means that you will not give your weakness in your writing or other things. And you threw your paper with the editor in chief. So consider yourself as the baby today that you have started your learning towards research paper. And then you will be able to understand. The world of research is very big. You can go for physics, chemistry, agriculture, mathematics, computer science, arts, history. But the one thing remains common. The one thing means the art of exploration, the art of searching, of finding a new problem, the art to find those works that are not complete. So research starts from finding those things that are not complete, that are having issues, and that needs improvement. So that are the founding questions in order to give yourself that if I'm doing a work, am I solving a problem? Am I improving something? Am I discovering something? Or am I completing something? So if you are able to answer these questions, then you will be able to understand that you are actually doing a research problem that is called novelty. So anybody can do any research. So the most interesting facts, which is important for all of you to understand, the articles that are published till 2019, because I will only take the data of last year, not of this year, because after this year passes, then we can improve the data. So the total papers are 114 millions. And now you can understand that only the PubMed holds 2.2 million articles, which over 20 million citations. And Scopus contains 43 million articles, which means 43 plus 2.2, which means 45 million articles are original articles and rest of the articles are like worthless. And you will be stunned to note everybody that 60% of the journals overall, if you see the entire database of the world and 60% of the journals, they are not valuable journals. 40% are good journals. And out of that 40%, 2 to 3% of the journals are having the impact that you are actually known as a profound scholar, profound researcher. Okay. In computer science, I don't know how many people know, but if your paper, if you publish one paper, I have a dream to publish one paper, but I will not tell you that what stage I am, because that can create a big panic. But I'm on the, I just want to say you that if I get this paper in next 4 months, I'm expecting, I will be becoming the one of the top researchers in the world that has the paper on that journal. That journal is the highest impact factor in the world in computer science. That is called IEEE Communication Surveys and Tutorials. 27 impact factor. I have papers in 4, 6, and 7, but now I'm playing a game of 27. But the idea is very difficult because why? It gets the papers of around 100 papers a day, and about, you can say, 3,000 articles are, or I can say 30,000 articles that journal receive every month. But in a year, they only publish 34 articles, which means you have to be among top 0.0001% in the world to make to that journal. And you can imagine that if you publish in that journal, what impact you will have. And if you are into like management, if you are into some sciences, and if you want to propose something new, then it is Nature. If you're having one paper in Nature, it is awesome. But if you're into management, if you are into economics, then there is one journal, everybody, please note it down. If you can publish that paper in that journal, you will be regarded as one of the profound scientists, or we can say the profound economist or the profound management scholar in the world. That will be research policy, because you will be stunned to note that in that policy journal, 20 reviewers review one paper. And after that, 2 associate editors, and after that, 1 editor in chief. So about 25 stages of reviews, they happen. Now imagine the review takes 1 year, and imagine after 1 year, how much comments you are getting. My one friend has submitted a paper of 74 pages in that journal. He got a comment of 214 pages. So, but he is able to make the through paper. And after that, he's one of the researchers who is working with Cork University. So you can say that the impact of the journal, ISI Web of Knowledge, and some people ask me this question. Now I will be clearing all the doubts one by one. So don't see the time now. Please focus on my knowledge. So don't worry for the time. If you want to leave the meeting, there is no problem. There is no problem for me to leave, but I will be completing the lecture. No doubt the time it will take, because I will be speaking like end. Now, many people say, what is meant by SCI, SCIE, and SSCI? What is this? Now, let me tell you, all these categories belong to one category called ISI Web of Science. ISI Web of Science is a separate body, and it controls 3 types of journals. It is called SCI, it is called SCIE, and it is called SSCI. Now, what is the difference between these three? The first category is called SCI, which means the paper will be published online. The paper will not have any hard copy, but they will have the same impact. No problem. And what is SCI? It is called Science Citation Index Expanded, in which the paper will be published online, but you can even have the hard copy of that journal. So the only difference is hard copy and soft copy. There is other no difference. And the third, I am having 3 papers in social sciences, and that's why I'm one of the top reputed researchers in Vietnam, SSCI. I'm having 3 papers in data technologies and application, one of the top journals in the world. Because in SSCI, only 137 journals are there. And 137 journals, you can say, if they produce 1370 papers a year, I can say you are one of them. You are, which means that you are among the top 0.0003% population of the world. So that's why you are credible. So SSCI means Social Science Citation Index. It is only for social sciences management. The second category that comes is called ESCI. ESCI means those journals which are above Scopus, but they are not ISI. They can become ISI. And the third category comes of Scopus. So Scopus is a body that is actually being controlled by Elsevier. Elsevier controls Scopus. And that's why if you review any paper of Elsevier, they always say you that, sir, have a free access to Scopus, because Elsevier controls Scopus. And the fourth category, which comes, is conferences, which are even Scopus indexed. And many people ask me, sir, which conference we should use? And I always tell them IEEE, Springer ASC, CCIS, LNCA, LNCS, everything you will find online, or ACM Digital Library. So after that, don't use any journal, any other thing that is all predatory. So if you say that the journal is indexed in Google Scholar or other things, unless or until the journal is having the baseline knowledge of Scopus, it is not regarded as a significant journal in the world. Okay. So the Google Scholar has taken up the bibliography, but I've already told you it has taken over the entire bibliography, which means it is claiming every article in the planet, but we don't have to go for every article. We require important articles. So that is the reason we don't use Google Scholar. We use other search engines, which I've already told you. Now say this, everybody, in the field of journals, this is the data that has been internal data that has been come to me. And you can see in terms of arts and humanities, only 1,632 journals are reputed. See this, for engineering, computing and technology, we only have 1,329 journals. It contains the top reputed SCI, SSCI and even Scopus journals and even ESCA. See this, everybody, chemistry, biotechnology and biology, we only have 545, 321. But the highest number of journals in the planet is with biological, that is called 4479 journals. And you can see mathematics in the world, only 97 journals are available. And that is the reason, everybody, that publishing in mathematics is one of the hard jobs in the world. And let me tell you, if you ask me that, sir, which is the most typical area that publication is very hard, it is the most important area is pharmacy. After that, it comes towards mathematics. Then it comes towards biological sciences, nature sciences, and computer science comes at number 10 or number 11. Management is the most easiest part in the world. If you are into management or economics and you are struggling for a paper, it means that it is a problem with your paper. It is not a problem with the journal because there are tons of journals that are available. Okay. So it's a matter for evaluation for you that your paper is not having a good quality. So see this, everybody, another important research that I've taken in front of you, 50% of research papers, 50%, they receive no citations. 90%, they glance over the content list, and only, let me tell you, everybody, less than 2% scientists read the abstract and introduction. And I've already told you, that's why I made the 3-pass approach. 1 pass, 2nd pass, the 3rd pass. And see this, 1% read rest of the paper. Because that is the reason 50% of the research papers have no citations. No citations. So why it is important to publish? So it is very important to understand, either publish or perish, have greater visibility, increase the chance for citations, great recognition and benefits for promotion, productivity, allowance, etc. I'm taking the name of my university right now. My university has got one Nature paper 4 months back. That person has published the paper in 77 impact factor. He is with Institute of R&D. And my university honors every paper, every bonus, because that's why I have got good bonuses. I am having a huge salary with me. Huge salary, I'm saying. That person with one paper, he has got a bonus of about 15 lakhs by the university. And it is not even taxed. So that is the reason, everybody, because most of the universities in Korea, and let me tell you, even we also get fund for getting publication in the open access journals. 50% of the fund of IEEE access or MDPA, it is paid from the pocket of my university. That is the advantage to work in a research orientation environment. And that is not being handled by the Indian university. 99% they don't handle. So the research paradigm, how to have the research paradigm, the most important thing is to have the discovery. What is the research question? The most important thing is to discover the research question, find the technical gaps, then make a dream to realize how to draw that research questions into your objectives. So the most important thing is there are lots of problems. Problems are questions in front of you. And in order to solve the problem, you need to scatter to after architecture. And after that, or whether it's a patent, and go for either publication of IPR or either the publication of a scientific paper. So that's how the paradigm methodology says. And the most important thing is creativity. Sometimes the simple questions take lots of time. Simple questions take lots of time, and the difficult questions are solved instantly. So the key skills, the research paper writing, you can see the most important thing is to write, write, and write. You will be to know that one person was asking me that, sir, your typing speed is very excellent. Now I would like to give you some of the answers. And even some person was asking me that secret of your energy. I will be answering both of these questions in this slide now. Now, one person was asking me that, sir, how do you know that at one I used to search the keys? But there is a hidden fact which I would like to inform all of you. Do most of the work chatting. And I have improved speed with chatting. I used to do lots of chatting with my friends on YouTube, on Yahoo chat, at that time on Messenger, and even on Facebook chat. Even I spent 30 minutes to write something on the community, and I write fast. And I do lots of emails because I have the power to write more and more. More I write, the better I'm getting flurication in the terms of typing. The most answer is write, write, and write. And that's everybody, that more you write, more you read, better you're getting the English. In 1 month, now I'm going to tell you, I'm saying that you will be stunned. 1 month, I read about 5 computer books, full 200 to 300 pages. I only sleep for 3 to 4 hours a day. Maximum, I work for 20 to 21 hours. Sometimes I don't sleep for three days. I do work. Secondly, I read more than 20 to 30. That is not like chip or open source. There are tons of magazines that are available. So more I'm reading, I'm improving my vocabulary. I'm improving my speed of conversation, and I'm improving. Write your thoughts and see which is the best paper in your template. Even I follow most of the journals and I download lots of papers. And every month I read about 70 to 80 papers full. So you can say that in every month, how much literature I am reading. I can speak on any topic in the planet if you want. So keep on writing the conclusions. What have you done? What is the notes? I use proper notes. I use conclusions. And after 1 month, I even revise everything that what was done in the last month. And now let's see what the mankind can do in this month. And after that, after 1 year, we can see that, yes, it was being done. And these were the problems of the last year. This has been solved, but these problems were not solved. Now let's focus on these problems. And that's how we scientists, we plan the strategy for next month, for next year. You will be stunned to note that right now, me and my team is not working for December or January or February. We have already finished the strategy for the next July 2021, which papers we have to publish by July 2021. Okay. So keep on giving the enthusiasm. So now the most important thing is the task of writing the paper can be daunting. And the most important thing is how to write the best publication and how to write a well-structured research paper. Now, before I start with this presentation, I would like all of you to please see this diagram. And watch this diagram very carefully, very, very carefully. Now see this, everybody, 90% of the research papers have the same structure. Now I'm talking of computer science. Soma, please keep your questions with you right now. Please don't get me distracted. I request all of you to please ask me the questions. I'm not going anywhere. I'm free right now. After that, I will be giving you the answers. So putting the questions in between, it is like distracting the speaker. And if any person is distracting me, he is a very bad. Please, if you don't bow it, very. And let me feel the work of research and let me do my work. Everybody. Very important. 90 to 95% of papers have the same structure. And what I'm going to give you, this is what the research as per me and my team have done. And this is a table and this is a diagram that we have actually designed with a mix of 15 to 20 experts that actually feel that if you write the paper with this pattern, you are actually getting the high chance of getting minor revisions only. Now see this, everybody, what is meant by abstract? Now the first thing is called abstract. I will not go on these things. I will be explaining those things. So the first thing is called abstract. After that, we have introduction. So see this, everybody, in the past decade, how much the research was focused, the basic, the application, the foundation of your study. It remains clear on why. Energy is a problem. Security is a problem. Why? What is the struggle for this area? Okay, sir, we say sensor networks have lots of problems in terms of energy, in terms of security, in terms of routing, everything. but why it is struggling? What is the problem behind the struggle? And see this, why, what is the purpose of the study? And 90% people, they don't write objectives of the study in introduction. So my second tip to all of you, like I've given you the first tip, please write from literature view. My second tip is that after you write the introduction theory, please write the objectives or contributions of this paper. So what are those contributions? I will be telling you how to write that. And after that, write organization of the paper. So after that, you can see we have to write literature review. Then we should write the methodology. What is the method? What is the model? What is the architecture, algorithm, flowchart? How you explain the working of your proposed work? That is the methodology. After that, give your results, experimentation. That, okay, sir, we have proposed a protocol. We have tested this protocol on this simulator on these parameters. What are the results? What are the graphs? And after that, go for discussion. What are the findings of the study? That, okay, sir, we have concluded that our protocol is better in this parameter 15% as compared to these protocols. This is called discussion, which means you are able to give the word that how you prove that you are right, you are better as compared to other word. That is called your discussion, explanation. And after that, give the conclusions. Conclusion should only focus on what is being highlighted, what is being proposed, and what are the analysis being done in order to produce the paper. And after that, add your conclusion, add your acknowledgements, and add the references. And even have told you what are the right number of references in the lecture. So this is what we will come back again in this lecture, but let us continue with this part now. So now you can understand, but what are the components? I repeat again, abstract, introduction, literature view, methodology, results, analysis and discussions, conclusion, future scope, references and acknowledgements. So these are the main important components of the paper. 99% of the paper will be only having these components. So the motivation will be to disseminate your work, 54%. For me, everybody, I'm into the 54% of the one that I want to disseminate, that I am one of the people who is actually doing the work in IoT. Because if you search IoT, like Internet of Drones, Internet of Nano Things, you will see my papers are coming at number one. Now you can see one of my inventions that you can see that the world has given this paper. Now suppose if you are on Google, you can search that. If you search Internet of Drones, you can see my paper is the number one paper in the world. This was the first paper ever written in the world. Actually, I was the person who actually given that concept to the world that actually Internet of Drone Things can be there. And now I'm publishing 5 more concepts this year, which will give me the huge elaboration that what type of researcher I am. So in order to disseminate my knowledge, you can see my search actually. So on Google, more than 37 keywords are reserved by my site, which is among the top 50 in the world. So the author publishing priority should be quality and speed, should be the board physical quality as well as the publication services. Okay, and let me tell you very openly, I'm saying that in order to improve the quality of English, I software. The first software that I use is Grammarly. Writing it, but the third software we can't declare. We can't declare, sorry for that. That is highly confidential. So what are authors and what are the behavior? The author behavior, we want to publish more. We want to have peer review essential, and we have to have wider dissemination. This is what the most important research has been done by Elsevier, and 36,000 people say that we want to publish better. We want to go for peer review. We want to have better dissemination. And that's why you can say that there was a time when I was struggling for 300 citations, and I have given 5 concepts of Internet of Things and 4 chapters in the intelligence. And now you can see that my citations are even going to touch 1650 in next 2 days, because some papers are already coming. So I will be touching, and this was the fastest, I can say, from 1400 to 1650 by 250 citations. I have just earned in 24 days, 250 citations in 24 days, which means every day I was earning 10 citations. So reader, we want integration. Browsing is very crucial. We want to read less. And that's why you can say we use the 3-pass approach. Now, let me come towards the main thing. Now, this is what I would like to inform all of you. After that, I will be coming towards the main aspects of the research paper. Now, for the next 20 minutes, please be very careful. So I'm sorry, I'm giving the lecture from the morning. Now I'm getting tired. So I'm very sorry, but I will try to improve the pitch as fast as possible. Now see this, everybody. There is a discussion in this diagram. 100 submissions are done to the journals. So 48 are sent as okay to the reviewers. 28% are sent back. Like you see, today only I have sent 2 papers back. I got 5 papers and 2 papers were returned back. Improve the paper again, improve the uniformity of the paper, improve the grammar, improve the correction of findings, and then resubmit the paper. Then we will review the paper. And I've told editor-in-chief that, sir, please be careful when you send me the papers, because I'm very strict in my review. If you say that, if you can see my pablons right now, let me show you my pablons. You will be all stunned to with whom you are to get the lecture today. Now, if you go to pablons.com, now you see over here. Let me open. But otherwise, you can just search my name. So let the matrix load. Be taking the name. So if you search computer science now, now you see what is my name in the world I'm saying. So if I click. You can see in the planet right now, if you just see tab of science collection only. If you see in the world, I'm at number 7 in the world. Number 7. And if you see the last 12 months, in computer science, I am the world number 2 in the planet, as per that. So that's why I'm very strict in my peer review. That's why I've got lots of awards and medals for best reviewer also. So see, revise is done as 28% and rejection 24%. Now see this. Now once it is revised, 66% papers are given that, okay, this is okay. And 10% paper are withdrawn, because sometimes the journals don't find the reviewers. Sometimes the reviewers are too late and they get the other opportunity. So out of the 66%, you will be stunned to note that 37% papers, only 37%. I'm saying 100% to 48, 48 to 66, 66 to 37. Now imagine out of that 100, today you are just moving towards 20 papers right now. 1% go for second review, and only 26% are given okay, and otherwise they go for revise, and 6% are withdrawn and 2% are rejected. And out of that 26%, 29% papers are getting published, which means not even 100%, which means we started from 100%, and out of that 29%, which means out of 100 papers, only 3 to 7 papers, they are published. Now imagine the game is from here to here. The game is not here. This is a loser game. I'm sorry. The game is from here to here. Now the question comes, you have to be among the top 48%. And after that, you have to become among the top 29% of the 66% of 31% of 48%. So not easy. Okay. And this is a global thing. I'm not talking of mathematics or other thing where the rejection rate can even touch up to, okay, can even touch up to 24%. SSCI, it can even touch to 21%. Now I will be telling you about the content of this lecture, but I will be skipping the part one because this is the basic part and you all know about it, but I will come towards part two, how to write a scientific manuscript, and listen to me very carefully. Now let me come towards the part B. This is just basic, so I just skip it because I don't have much time now, because I have to be prepared for the next 2 lectures. I have 2 more lectures after this. Okay. Now, the first important thing, research manuscript, how to write it. Now, this is the central part of the lecture. And in just 15 minutes, I'm going to change your life. So the first thing, we should avoid the first expressions, which in the paper, and even some people will say, I, we, nothing. Proposed. Okay. The most important thing is your language grammar. I will be telling you what type of tenses you have to use. So let me start with the tenses. Now, the first important thing, literature review, write it down. Literature review should be in the past tense. Why? Because it is already proposed. Introduction should be in the past tense, because you are actually writing that material which is already observing, which is already known to the world. You're just taking that information from the different aspects in your own language, but that is not your created work. That is actually done. That is actually known. If you're doing something like wireless sensor network, I'm not designing wireless sensor network. It is actually designed. So it is again in the past tense. Now the third thing, methodology. That is done. That is right now. That is in the present. So that should be in the present form, present tense. Findings and conclusions. Again, it should be in the present tense. Conclusion, present tense. Future scope, that okay, sir, by taking this, we can conclude that we will observe this thing. That will be in the future tense. We will find out. After that, abstract. Abstract should be in the present come past tense, because in the baseline of the study, you have to write some basic information, and the objective of the paper is conclusions are given. So abstract is the only thing in which the first opening lines should be in the past tense and rest of the abstract should be in the present tense. Okay, now let us start with some English. But otherwise, if you have taken my course of 4 or 5 days, I would have taken you towards the word of how to actually write the paper in scientific terms. That is my another lecture. So it takes 3 hours lecture. So I will not use that lecture today. But I will be using this one, words and expressions to avoid it. So the first thing, jargon and preferred, a considerable amount of, use much, on account of, because. So make the paper short, make the paper consistent. Number of, several. That's why if you see a number of, you can just even replace the word with several. That is what we do the English editing. Referred to as, called. In number of cases, some. Has capacity to, can. It is clear that, clearly. It is apparent that, apparently. Employ, use. Fabricate, make. So these are the words that actually lose your interest of the paper, and these are the words that you must use. Take the photo of this slide. Please take the photo. I give you 10 seconds. I hope you have taken. So word choice. It should be from the Bloom's taxonomy, knowledge, comprehension, analysis, synthesis, and evaluation. So these are the main words that you should use in the paper. Now let's talk of these things, but you can take another photo of this one. I will give you again 5 seconds. Please take the photo. So these are the main things that you should use in order to make predictions, conclusions, used to explain, apply old information, comprehension, and knowledge. So you should use these words in your literature. So that's why I'm telling you, writing the paper is also called English. And even I take English classes here. So in English, you have to be very much improved. And I'm not an ISC student, I'm a CBSE student. So now the manuscript structure, we will be talking of abstract, introduction, body of knowledge, everything. So let's talk of the structure now. And let me come towards the main components. Now understand carefully the next 10 minutes, that's all. The title, I've already told you, don't write a novel, an improvised, nothing. Give the title properly. What is the name of your proposed work? Clearly describe the content. You have seen my topic also, my Springer also paper. The complete name of the protocol was written, which means what was the protocol, on what is were based, and for which application it was based. Authors, please ensure that you should write ORC ID and use official email IDs. Abstract, describe what is being done. What is a gist of the paper? Keywords, and this is very important, everybody. Keywords, people just, they can use anything other thing, but actually the paper gets indexed or the paper is getting more reads. Because if you see ResearchGate, the top scientists in the planet, they even are touching 2 lakh also. I'm touching 2,75,000 today. It is one of the top 3% in the world in ResearchGate. That is one of them I am. Introduction, it explains the problem. What is the problem that are you finding? What is the objective of the study? Only focus on the problem. Method, what is the methodology? How you have taken algorithm, steps, flowchart, results, experimentation, your own results. After that, discuss how you compare your proposed work with the existing works, references and appendix. If you have want to have some supplement data, you can do with some other journals. Now I will go to the title only. The first thing, describe the paper content clearly. It should include the keywords. And let me tell you, very important, everybody, the title should contain, and the keywords should also contain some words from the title also. Nobody will tell you. Like suppose if I take IEEMARP routing protocol based on ACO for wireless sensor networks, which means the keywords are IEEMARP, ACO, sensor networks, routing, which means four keywords are already coming. And one more important question, many people ask me how many keywords we should use. If you are writing a Scopus paper, 4 to 6. If you are writing a conference paper, 3 to 5. If you are writing a SCI paper, 4 to 6. Maximum 6 keywords are enough. Enough. Second, don't use abbreviations like, okay, sir, WSN. No, don't use any abbreviation in the title. Never use abbreviation. And most important thing, always search the search engine before planning the title, because sometimes the title comes the same exact. I use Google search for that. And even you can use these paper searches and then find the title name. Otherwise, it could be plagiarism issue. No doubt it is novelty, but it can come under plagiarism. Now see this, everybody, very important. Now listen to me very, very carefully. For the abstract, 90% people, they fail. I can say fail. Okay, go. Let's please go. I don't want to take the paper. Even today, I got 3 papers in my journal. Only 2 papers are through. 1 paper rejected, sir. I'm not able to understand the abstract. Maximum words for the abstract should be minimum 200. Write it down, minimum 200 and maximum, no doubt, journals, some journals can take 500, but the perfect abstract is up to 400 words. 200 to 375 or 400, perfect abstract. Now, after that, what is the main baseline that, okay, sir, we studied sensor networks. What is the application that we have studied? After that, you should write what is the objective of the paper. You should write like this. The main objective of the paper is. That's why I'm saying you, the first 2 lines, problem formulated, these are known as the past tense. After that, what is the objective of the paper? After that, what is being proposed? Like, okay, we have done this new thing in this work. After that, experimentations conclude. And please don't write like this thing. Experimentations conclude that our proposed work is better. No, prove experimentations conducted on this simulator on these parameters and concluded that our work is 15% better in this as compared to these. So compare your proposed findings or methodology and results with the analysis section. And then it is called a perfect abstract. And that's why I'm saying investigated, purpose, method, results, and conclusions. So these 5 things make up the abstract. So common mistakes, too much background information. Okay, sir, 7 lines of wireless sensor. No, 2 lines. That's all. No figure or image should be there. And some people say, what is graphical abstract? Very important. Okay. Now, some SCA journals will ask you for graphical abstract. So graphical abstract should never be included in the paper. It's a separate thing. What is graphical abstract? What you have proposed, like you have proposed an algorithm, you have proposed a novel architecture model, or you can say the main diagram of yours. The main diagram that is proposed by you, that diagram, and write 4 lines. What is the main theme or the objective of your study? That becomes a graphical abstract. That is all. And don't reference anywhere that, okay, 3 number reference, 4 number reference. No. And don't use abbreviations. No abbreviations in abstract. And now let us talk of introduction. I'm saying you again. First of all, give the broad information regarding previous works. What is the application? What is the need for the study? That, okay, sir, energy is a problem because it can scale down the sensors. Okay, sir, this is a problem, need for the study. What is the focus of your study? What is being proposed? What is being analyzed? After that, give the summary. And then after that, please, nobody will tell you what are the objectives of the paper. If you are writing a conference paper, 1 page. If you're writing a Scopus paper, 1.5 page. If you are writing an SCA paper, maximum 1.5 to 2 pages. That should be your introduction. And please, after introduction, this information, write your objectives, contributions, and then write, very important, organization of the paper. Whenever I check the papers, 60% I don't find organization. So please add the organization of the paper. And common mistakes, too much or enough information, too much, unclear purpose, confusing structure, and anti-source. So anti-source means that you are using some basic vocabulary that is actually not required. So please be on the focus. I've already told you, again, I'm telling you, basic information, previous research, need for the study, focus of the paper, that is objective and contribution, summary, and then write organization of the paper. So the clearly state should have that what is the problem that is being investigated, that, okay, sir, I'm into cloud computing. I investigated the problem of security. I investigated the problem of load balancing. Background, reasons for conducting the research. State how your work differs from the published work. That is why we can say the research questions, that, okay, sir, the problems are coming over here. Many previous researches have stated. And after that, you should write the objectives and clearly define the experiment. Now understand what are the objectives. Now see this. In objectives, don't write at number one that, okay, sir, this we have done the analysis, this we have done the review of literature. No, review of literature is not an objective. So the first objective can be to analyze this parameter and to add this technique to make it better. Second thing, what are you going to propose? Architecture, model, protocol, whatever. After that, you should write experimentation that, okay, sir, we will conduct experimentation on these parameters. And last but not the least, you should add what comparison you will do as compared to this protocol with these protocols. So these 4 to 5 objectives will be from your research questions that will give you the novelty towards your work. And after that, we will go for methods and materials. You should write, what is the study? Now, let me tell you, I will go towards this thing. Now the research, now after that, you can do the literature view. Now after the literature view, now let me come towards this thing. Now with this, I would like to inform all of you. Now, if you have done for the proposed work, okay. Now, some people will say proposed work. No, it should not be. It should be given the title of your own work. That, okay, sir, this is my protocol and this is what. Now, the first thing is number A, it should be your system model. System model means that how the system actually works mathematically. Mathematically, very, very important. How is the structure being followed? Number B part, it is called operation or working. So working in that, you should first of all give the steps. Step number one, step number two, step number three. And then you should write your flowchart. The steps should be formulated with the form of flowchart and architecture. And then you should give your algorithm. That is as per we can write. Now after that, this is the section, and then you can find your answer in terms of findings. Findings means that what is the experimentation. Now, before you should write the experimentation, you should write something with regard to your platform. What is the platform that you use? MATLAB, or you have used dataset, and 90% people, they make the mistake that they just give the name of the dataset. So you can give the name of the dataset. You should also write description of the dataset, and you should even write the source of the dataset. Very important. And after that, you should write your parameters for experimentation. That, okay, sir, we have used these parameters for experimentation. Simulation parameters should also be there. And last but not the least, before you should go for some experimentation, you should write your assumptions. Assumptions are very, very important. Okay, and then you should write your parameters. That, okay, sir, my first parameter is routing. My second parameter is security. My third parameter is delivery ratio. What are the different parameters? That, okay, sir, I am doing some parameter with regard to mathematical modeling. I'm doing precision, accuracy, like you can say precision point or whatever you want to have. And after that, please add data values in tables and then add your graphs. This is all what you will say in the C part, that is called your methodology, or you can say findings or experimentation. And then you should write another section called analysis section. So you should give some comparison of your proposed work with existing works. With existing works, what is being done? How you can compare? And one more thing, everybody, 90% papers will also fail, because 70% people, what they do, they just compare with existing works, that what are the standard works. No, if you want to compare with standard works, that is okay. That is okay. I'm saying okay, but not enough. But not enough. So you must compare your work with some existing works, which means by the other authors, that, okay, sir, if I'm proposing some AI-based, breast cancer-based methodology, I should not compare with the basic foundations. I should also compare with what other person, like every person like Ali Khan or Rashid Ahmed, or other person like Anthony De Silva. All these peoples have done these things, which means we are comparing with our work, that what is our model accuracy, or with some technique. And then, everybody, you should write your conclusion. What is being concluded? And in this conclusion, everybody, there is a parameter for 70, 20, and 10. Now, in 70%, you should write your own proposed work. Own work. What is the methodology you proposed? Methodology you proposed. And 20%, what are the results that you have observed? And 10%, what analysis overall that you have observed? Overall analysis. And then you should write the future work, or you can say it is better, you should write future scope. So in the future scope, you should write that what add-on parameters, that, okay, sir, today we have done the comparison on these areas, that, okay, routing, security, delivery, but okay, sir, we will, in the near future, we will improve the throughput, we will improve energy. So what add-on things that you should write to add, you should try to enhance your main works. And after that, you can write your acknowledgements, or you can write your references, which should be in the APA style. And that is what the research paper should actually look like. And that's how we should avoid all the mistakes that has to be happening over there. So I should come towards the most important thing, that is called the figures. So 90% people, they make the problems in the figures. So in the figures, I would like to inform you most important thing. Now see this. Now in the figures, the most important thing that you should draw the figures in infographics or MS Visio, and mostly for the chapters and for the conferences, it is 300 DPI. But for SCI papers, we recommend 600 DPI. Okay, so that's the reason. So enhance your enhancement. And one more thing, everybody, nobody in the world will tell you, don't use JPG. JPG is not a good format. So I only recommend you that either you use TIFF format, or either you use .png format. So that will give you the better clarity of the images, better clarity. Okay. And if you're working on tables, everybody, most important, draw the tables, draw with Excel. And if you're working with graphs, then I recommend infographics or Visio. That is what we should use in order to make the graphs. So that's all from my side, everybody. I hope in the last 2 days and this day, you have changed yourself. You have got lots of knowledge. Now the house is open for next 5 minutes for the question answer session. After that, this is all the end. Rupa ma'am.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Hello, Rupa ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am. The lecture is over, ma'am. Now the house is open.
Sir.
And you can start.
Yeah. Yes, sir. That's why I'm giving a chance to the participants. They're going to ask any question like that.
So good luck, everybody. And thank you for calling.
Sir, Jyoti ma'am,
for flowchart again, I'm
hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, madam.
Good evening, everyone. It's my privilege to propose vote of thanks in this webinar. On behalf of Bangalore Institute of Technology, I extend my hearty thanks to our dynamic principal, Dr. Ashwath MU, for his enthusiastic support and motivation for organizing this international webinar on high quality research, approach, design, and publishing. So I would like to share a quote by Santosh Kalwar. It does not matter where you go, what you study, what matter is what you share with yourself and the world. Thank you, Dr. Anand Nair, sir, for accepting our invitation and sharing your expertise in depth on how to write effective research proposal, thesis, an SCI paper for publication in reputed journal, and about various research tools, publications. We're all enlightened by your talk. Thank you for your time, sir. I thank all participants for their active participation in this webinar. I thank Dr. Kupa, Chairman, VIT IPR Cell, Dr. K.V. Vijayendra, Chairman, R&T Cell, VIT, and Organizing Committee Coordinators, Professor Vidya, Dr. Vijay Kumar, Professor Mamta, Ms. Vidya, and Ms. Vinay for their cooperation in successful execution of this webinar. Finally, thank all HODs, my fellow colleagues of VIT, for making this webinar a success.